Today's You Know What Dude podcast on riotcast.com.
Yeah. Such an idiot. You literally just, I mean, Deepu works out the shot.
So he pointed his finger at me to wait.
Yeah, you should have, because your fat torso, your wide hips.
I want to be on the show, Bobby.
Yeah, well, you're on the show. All right, this is going to be a fuck. You know, Will got me off on the wrong fucking foot. You dumb fucking, I love life energy. Fucking piss me off. Will Sylvins on the fucking show.
Hello, everybody.
I don't like now that you went the other way.
I can't lose.
You can't win, dummy. You've lost. Trust me.
Oh, I can't. Wait. So when do you say I can't lose?
Huh?
I can't win. You can't say I can't lose?
You can't say I can't lose because of, oh God.
You never say I can't lose. I can't lose.
Listen, man. You can't. You've lost. I love you so much. That's all I'm saying. Go around the room, Deepu. Introduce everybody, please.
Hey, everybody. Taking over Scopo's duty. Deep. Oh, God.
Take your time.
Wow.
Oof. I usually don't introduce everybody.
I got it, Scopo, Bobby.
Go ahead.
Yeah, let the expert do it.
Well, I think everyone knows Will is here.
Yep.
Say hi, Will.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Shout out to everybody who loves Will Sylvins. I love you right back. I can't lose.
I love you, Will.
Thank you.
You're one of the few people I believe are on my side completely.
I am on your side.
Thank you.
Then we got Mike Brown, very funny comic.
Yo, very funny comic.
Yo, what up? @ Yo Mike Brown on Twitter. Blap, blap, blap. I love you back, man. I love you in the streets, man. I love you. I love you in your city, in your farm, wherever you at. Thanks for listening, man. YKWD, Chain Gang. Blah!
So his response was way better than what I said.
I liked it.
How the fuck am I supposed to follow that?
That's his thing.
How's this?
That's his thing.
Just say your name, and you don't have to fucking do blap blap or love anybody.
A fucking rap battle. I'm sorry, Mike. I'm not from New York.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hi, I'm Andrea Allan. Blap 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 blap.
I felt racial, but it's all right.
Oh, relax.
That's all right.
That's all I got.
That's all you got. That's fine. I liked it.
Thank you.
I was fine with it.
I'm a classy bitch.
You are a classy bitch. Mm-hmm. And of course, we got Chris Scopo. Producer, and we got videographer and video producer Deepu to the fucking ooh.
What's up? Front of the bus funny. What's going on?
Oh, wow.
Jesus Christ. Where is it?
You didn't like that?
Where is it?
With the hanky sheef.
Where is it? Where is it?
Right here.
I want you to wrap it around his head like a turban.
Wrap it around India.
It actually looks pretty good on me.
Seems natural.
Wow.
Wrap it around twice.
Mike Vecchione's on his way.
Yeah, good for
just
him.
Just got out of Red Eye.
TV. All those rehab.
Red Eye.
So we're here. This is the second show we did today. I'm going on vacation next week to the White Mountains, motherfucker.
So your third
you're not
floor
allowed.
Of your house?
What's that?
The third floor of your house?
I have a ranch.
Oh.
I have a mid-century contemporary ranch.
Is that what you put on the salad?
I loved it.
Oh, I don't want to laugh at it, but I can't help myself.
That was good.
Why are you looking around for approval? People are lying. You had a lot of stereo.
Bobby, you don't need approval. You don't need approval.
Well, the microphones work. They work fine.
Why are you looking around?
You don't have to do either or. Just be in the middle. Pull back up. Pull back up. Right there. Talk.
Hey.
See? I hear you.
So tell us about your ranch trenching.
I don't know what that means. I don't know what ranch trenching is.
Ranch dressing.
Okay. Ranch dressing.
I heard that mess up.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
Ranch. I have a ranch, a mid-century contemporary ranch house.
And that's where you're going?
That's where I live. No, I'm going up to New Hampshire. The White Mountains of
now,
New
who's
Hampshire.
Who's going to carry you up there?
I'm going to drive myself. Yeah, I'm not going up the mountain. It's in the mountains, but not up them. But I will be hiking. I hike a lot.
From
for 10
your
minutes?
House to the train is not hiking.
What's that?
Your house to the subway is
we'll
not hiking.
We'll take the fucking subway. I'm a fucking
Why
peasant.
Subway to the
fuck, you think I own a Metro card, you fucking asshole? I fucking have a Platinum Amex, bitch. I'll take an Uber or a fucking limo, motherfucker. Or my Honda Pilot. No. When I go up to New Hampshire, I hike, man. There's hiking trails. I'm not saying I fucking camp out for the night and eat squirrels, small game. I take a little walk in the woods with my wife and my kids and, you know, and come close to death, and then I come back.
Mm. They have bears up there?
They do have bears. They have they actually have this up right behind my uncle's house. If you go up these trails, they go back and then they split up. And if you go way back, there's a bear den. They call it Devil's Cave. And they have all these caves where the fucking bears live inside there.
You been there?
No, I don't fuck with that.
Is it
my uncle has,
is it
though.
Black bear, brown bear, or polar bear?
Well, does it matter what color? I mean, where are we at today?
Any twinks up there?
What?
God. You know, bears, twinks. Oh, I mean, you know. All right. Well, should I not try?
Where the hanky
sheef? I already got it.
He's Jesus like Christ. A mute.
Can you do me a favor and tie the knot you tie hooks onto string with?
When I was a kid, when I would get in trouble, my parents would send me to go hiking by myself. Like out in the forest.
Holy no, they just wanted you to leave.
Yeah.
They were hoping for
reverse runaway.
Yeah, I was hungover once, and they're like, "Go walk around for 6 hours
it's
and
called
come back."
It's called reverse runaway.
Yeah, they sent
is
me
is that what it's called?
Yes.
Are you just made that up, right?
No,
that's a Willism.
Google no. Reverse runaway. Is that your parents trying to make you run
I
home?
I refuse to Google anything you've said.
Okay.
Because I don't want the internet to know that I Googled it. I don't want there to be a record of me going reverse runaway. Or fucking ranch to Bessing, whatever the fuck you said.
Ranch to Bessing.
You ran. So they just made you leave the house.
Yeah, they would. They always send me. They would send me to boarding school. They would send me away every summer for like months. They just, and one time I got super wasted at a family party.
Yeah.
In Arizona. How old? Maybe like 13.
You got 13? Wasted at 13?
Holy
yeah.
Shit. My birthday's on New Year's Eve, so I was just drinking everyone's drinks, and I came home and jumped into my parents' bed and was like, I'm drunk as a skunk. And they're like, you're going for a fucking hike tomorrow morning. And they just sent me out into the desert.
How you know when to come back?
They were just like, call us.
The mountain lines up.
Call us to Earth. Feel better. And they just sent me off.
That's like what the Native Americans used to do to the old people.
Yeah.
Did they give Jesus. You a knife or like,
no, like
a matches or anything?
No, just like a, you know, bottle.
Was it dark
water.
Or was it?
Would you go early
in
the morning?
Daytime, in the daytime. Yeah.
So they weren't really good parents.
I mean, they were.
Well, you got drunk at 13 and then
yeah.
They were like, just go away.
No, they were good. I mean, they did their
How
best.
How good can they be? They let you get drunk at 13.
They're, I don't know. It's Canada. Like, no one cares.
When can you start drinking in Canada? 16?
18 in most places, 19 is the highest drinking age. But then I drank wine at home. Like, it wasn't a big, I mean, I don't drink anymore because I drank it all, but.
Are you done? Are you done with alcohol?
Yeah.
Sober?
How long?
About a year.
That's pretty good.
Congrats. Yeah.
So now, are you off drugs too?
No. Fucking loser.
What drugs?
Just weed. I used to fuck with cocaine a little bit, but not
really.
Anymore. Yeah. Mm. So.
Well, you know, when I first met you, it was on the Keith and the Girl show.
That was fun.
The original podcast, as they call it.
Yeah.
And you were fucking shockingly honest.
Thank you.
I mean, for me, I was like, what the fuck? I was like listening. Like, did she just fucking? Yep, she said that.
That's how I roll.
Yeah, I mean, all these sexual fucking crazy things that happen with you and your, was it your boyfriend, right? Or just a dude?
I don't know. There hasn't been a boyfriend in the picture for like a really long time.
No
what's
shit.
A, what's yeah. a long time?
Yo, Will is
on it. This is Will's creepy vote.
Are you
what he goes into.
What's a long time?
Are you applying for the position?
I just want to know. It's a long time.
Will is inquisitive as fuck.
Like, if it's too long, you're crazy. If it's too short, that dude is still around. If it's medium, then, you know, I'm stepping in.
I didn't even know. No, you're not.
No, you're not.
You're not stepping in.
Michael, I know you have a connection with him. I mean, but that has to break it a little bit. That has to.
I'm stepping in.
It doesn't make sense, but it makes sense, and I don't get it. Am I going crazy? Why do I understand Will?
The logic was airtight, though. Logic was good.
Go ahead.
I've been in like fucking stupid relationships that are like 4 months long, so I don't know if you count that. Like, serious, it's been like 5 years.
Maybe. And the last 4 month one?
I'm kind of in one right now, but
before, you have a boyfriend now.
Situationship. I don't know if I would say it. Yeah.
Y'all just fucking.
I'm. Yeah. Again. Yeah. I don't
Is
know.
He a comedian?
Yeah.
Do you break that rule?
Yes, I fuck almost exclusively comedians.
You fucking funny guys.
Yes.
Really? Yeah. Whoa, that's crazy.
Where else you gonna meet guys at?
Yeah, I'm at open mics every fucking night. The buffet's there. Why not, you know, sample it?
Is that what you call us?
Yeah.
I'm offended.
You know what? Me and my friend, we have a game that we play.
It's called Who's Suck Your Way to the Top?
What's sloppy? Exactly. It's the best game in the world.
First of all, have you seen the open mic audience? She has to date comedians.
What do you mean?
I don't know what that means.
Open mic audience is...
Can you say audience?
Audience.
All right, go ahead.
Open mic audience...
Is what?
Is a mess.
Right.
It's a bunch of yous and a bunch of girls that look like you.
Did you say me's?
He's like, he's two utes.
Oh, yeah. No, he's saying that it's just me in the audience. Go fuck yourself. There's a couple of you, too, with a fucking bike pack on.
Exactly. Some me and stupid. You in the audience with wigs, and it's a mess. So she had to, you know,
it's
smash
gorgeous
comedians.
Mess. Well, it's like we have this game where we go, how much would you have to pay me to fuck him?
Right.
And we have to get a dollar amount. And if it's nothing, if it's free, then it's like, oh, that guy's pretty, yeah, that's pretty
So, okay, let's do that right now. Okay. Let's go around the room.
Okay.
We'll start with Depot. How much would it cost to fuck Depot? I'll give you.
I'll pay you $100.
Let's do it right now. I'll give you $100 to fuck Depot. How much you give her? How much?
See, it's not about.
Wait, I don't know. I don't know. To fuck me or him?
No. She had to pay her.
I knew
me.
He'd fuck it up. Yeah. Because he's just dumb.
It's what.
You know, I got called dumb by a lot of you today, and I'm offended.
I'm sorry.
All right.
Depot, $500.
Five bills.
$500.
Wow. Okay.
Why are you so upset? You're looking.
You don't know how much I am yet, though. Yeah.
That's true.
That could be half a rent.
Yeah, but
you're not free, though.
Yeah, but you're also
not a dollar.
You're a headliner. You're a headliner.
That don't
mean
shit.
Hold on. Does that factor in the equation?
Hmm?
Does that factor into the equation?
What factor does it?
They're a headliner. They're
no, it doesn't.
No, it's just straight
I like that Chris is nervous.
Straight up.
Chris don't want to be more expensive than me.
I don't know.
Because he goes to the gym and I eat pizza. He's like, you're a headliner. Shut the fuck up.
Sex appeal.
You got fans.
Listen, man, she has morals. It's not about headliners. It's about how much. All right, now how much would you do for Chris?
$250.
$250. Okay. All right.
I'm
okay.
Sorry, D. You're looking at me. All right. Like I betrayed you.
I'm a pretty good looking guy, I thought.
Hang
what
on one
fuck?
Second. Will Savitz.
All right.
Will Savitz, how much? 1,000. 12,000.
You auctioned him off.
A Rolex.
My father's love. 900.
Wow.
I'll take it. Wow. I got $900 in my pocket right now.
I mean, I don't have to be beholden to it.
You're fine. You're doing good. Don't fucking.
Wait, hold on. Have you seen Will's dick?
No,
stop. That's bullshit. That's illegal.
Why can't I do
that's
that?
That's bullshit.
Okay, wait.
Foul.
Because you know it's going to be
foul.
$2. That's what
shut up.
Foul.
Shut up.
You got your two.
Shut up.
You show up.
Mike.
You got to keep it pure.
Mike.
Keep it pure.
Mike, you and your 6-incher, what do you got? I mean, I'm sorry. Mike.
Why are you fucking bastard?
Mike.
What do you got, Mike? Mike, look at him. Look at his face.
I know, Mike.
Got great eyes. Great eyes.
He's too pretty, though. I'm sorry. You're beautiful. You're not really my style.
$10,000.
What does that mean?
Jesus.
How much?
He's so pretty. Yeah, it's a little too pretty for me.
Okay.
I don't like to compete in the looks department with men. I'm going to give you... $10,000.
$10,000?
Yeah,
$10,000. And Will for 900?
Yeah.
What the hell are you talking about, Mike? She fuck you 10 times and have money left over before she even got money. Understand that? I'm just saying.
So
she
hasn't
even seen your dick yet. She hasn't even seen your dick yet.
Hey, you said don't bring the dick up.
Yeah. But I'm losing. $10,000?
I ain't up yet. Let me finish.
$10,000?
Before you start bringing up fucking Will a baseball bat.
The human love couch. How much?
Love couch. Love couch.
You shut those curtains, man.
Mike's coming in.
I'm
going
to say $1,000.
A thou- Whoa, stop.
How do you feel?
Stop. Hey, Michael,
that's Sylvan's and a blowjob with Chris.
I won, by the way. I just want to say something. I won.
You fucked Debo before me?
He got on shorts. He has a med shirt.
Actually, that's true. I didn't think of, okay.
Wait, hold on. Whoa. She can change her mind.
No, she can't.
She can change her mind.
Pair pressuring her.
You fucked Debo before me.
You dick pressing her.
You dick pressing
her. Wait a minute. You'd fuck Debo. So you're saying he's $5. I'm 1,000?
I bet you'd be better in bed.
Yes.
No. Whoa. That's a different question. That's a totally different
question. No, that factors in.
All right. That's true. That does factor in.
About the 10,000 then.
All right. Now.
10,000 because I just want to piss you off.
Yeah.
Because I know you.
Right.
Okay.
There's
okay.
more at play because I know you.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Now go. Okay.
What did
so
I say?
So you just fuck a stranger for
500.
500. All right. I'm dropping you down to 200.
Oh, no!
You can't do that!
She said 1,000 times!
I'm getting pussy!
No.
I'm getting pussy!
No, fuck that.
I don't respect Amanda anymore.
There's like a deep pool special.
My name is
she
not
got
Amanda.
Hey, take my ATM and go to the bank. Get 250. They'll get, you know what? Get 500 for me and you both.
You're going to close your account.
I'm just playing you off.
I'm stupid. I don't make independent films, motherfucker. Is he up here?
No, he's coming now.
Okay. Oh God. That's funny, dude. Oh, 10 grand.
Hold on. You got to do Mike when you get here.
Okay. I mean, I just know you, so I just want to fuck with you.
Stop fucking letting his self-esteem up.
Wait.
You know, the sad thing is you let him change your mind, but you won't let him change your mind.
You know why, though. You know
wait,
why.
Wait, now let's factor in headliner, huge dick.
I'm not a size queen.
And also friendship. Factor in friendship. Yeah, can I get like
spots right here? Spots.
I got it right here.
What is this? Spot.
Available spots.
First of all, I got a spot right there in that chair every week open.
I'm
right
in.
There. I'll dump lesbo hips right out of the fucking door. I'll move some
furniture.
Hey,
I'll move some furniture.
Listen to me. I will kick field hockey hips right out of the studio
all right.
and stick you in there.
All right.
Grandma shorts.
I'm taking all your jobs.
It's you know, like a tablecloth.
Yeah. They're comfortable.
How come nobody told my Scopo shorts? Holy shit, bro.
You see this shit?
They're comfortable.
You gonna fuck up with this? Do you see these shorts?
I like them.
At least $750.
Thank you. Thank you. Very comfortable.
Mike, you're just so fucking cocky that I just
want
to.
What do you mean?
But Mike's not cocky. He's not that cocky.
You fuck me for $10,000 because I know you.
Yeah.
Strangers get a deal, but your friends get nothing.
You listen, man, you're too cocky. Blah, 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 blah. That scares people.
That's what happens in the bedroom. I'm just getting you ready. You know, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying?
That's fucking terrifying.
It should be. It should be.
Your mind's
going
to be like this. Blah, blah. Swap, swap.
Ate all y'all.
Mine's going to be like.
Oh, are you nursing a cat? What the fuck?
Yeah, what
is
are you?
That?
Are you a baby
I'm
goat?
I'm going to nurse that cat.
Yeah, nurse the hell out of that cat.
I say you up.
Look at his face.
That cat going purr.
You don't even know how to make a cat purr.
It's kind of like a phone ringing.
Hang on 1 second. Yeah, you're an iPhone cat. Do it. Hang on 1 second. Hang on 1 second. Stop. Do a cat purr. You got it.
Purr.
Oh my God! Please
that's
try
a cat purring.
One more time. No, that's a human being going purr. That's saying the word purr.
Roll your tongue, dude. I thought you said you could eat pussy.
Purr. I can eat pussy. Listen,
listen.
Got nothing to do with purring.
Not doing it right.
Here, Bobby.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
If I do it, I'll purr. I never
I'll
said
do it. Ready? Watch
purr.
This.
Shh.
Mm-hmm. What kind of cat is that? That cat that eats pizza?
That's a Siamese.
That's a cat that eats pizza.
It's a jungle
that's
cat.
A cat with a deviated septum.
Is Mike right. coming up the stairs of the train
no,
station?
No, he's on the way down. He took a car
can
down
you,
here.
Can you never
eye.
Tell me that he's almost here when he's not fucking here? You fucking stupid wop that sticks up for your dumb wop friend.
That's what you're doing for
fucking
500.
Wide hip.
All right.
You wide hip assholes stick up for each
you
other.
Know, he probably is a good so
no,
wife.
It's been a long day, Scopo.
I don't. You know, it's hurt. It hurts.
Fucking stupid haircut twins.
I need my Italian brother here.
Yeah, well, he's not here, so fuck him.
Mike's been on his way 17 times now.
Fucking Mike, where? I did red eye, dude. I did a couple zingers.
Oh God.
How much are these open micers paying you to have sex with you?
Nothing.
Wow.
I'm doing it pro bono.
And I gotta pay $500?
Oh my God, you're so butthurt about this.
I am.
Wait, you
got
to
bought on the lower price.
You're fucking 250. You should fucking jump. Oh, you're 500.
No, he's 500.
You're 500.
Yeah. He's two, Chris. It's either fuck Chris
you
twice.
You beat Will.
500.
He ain't beat me.
That's the only time I ever will.
Because I could afford mine.
What was yours again?
$900. I got it right here.
$10,000. Like you, $10,000. Somebody,
sorry,
like
baby.
Somebody, have to pay you $10,000.
Can I say something? You know why? It's your fake eyes.
You got fake eyes. Mike's eyes are great.
Mike got fake eyes.
You got contacts.
Are those contacts?
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are.
Are they?
But you can find out for $10,000.
I know they're not.
Those are contacts.
No, they're not.
Somebody getting a hanky sheef.
Yeah, I don't know why I laughed at that.
No, they're not. You did a little chuckle. I'll take it.
Will, are you counting money right now?
I'm getting my $900.
He's counting like a dollar. Get it.
Are you fucking getting your train money to go to Haiti?
He's going to take
this. You fucking cocksucker. Put your wrinkly money away from your bike.
Oh, my God.
From my bike.
Hey, listen. So, you're dating a comic right now.
Well, I don't know if, like, it's not super serious, but I'm seeing.
Can you say his name?
How much did he pay you?
Okay. I'm seeing means I'm fucking.
Hey, yeah.
All right. Can we chill? Can we look? It was fun and games, but you get very aggressive with women, and you've done this before on the show.
I apologize.
No, it's fine. But just chill. You fucking. This isn't NWA. Okay, we're not dropping a fucking rap album in '97. Okay, chill the fuck out.
Hey, by the way,
yo, how's that pussy mixing?
By the way, are you gonna see that movie?
Yes.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
It's going to be good.
Yes. I was into NWA when it first popped off, son. Oh. Blah, blah, boo, blah.
Yeah. For real?
Took, 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 took.
What was the first song?
Yeah, Bobby. Yeah.
What was the first song?
The first song? Straight Outta Compton, bitch.
That was not the first.
Straight Outta Compton. Crazy
hit.
Motherfucking name Ice Cube. From a gang called Nick with Attitude. It is hard off. Almost.
All the listeners are waiting on that one.
My fucking heart's in my chest.
I can't breathe.
It's coming.
It's like I'm not about to be Bobby's friend no more. Second shit. God
did
damn.
Did you see Mission Impossible?
Yeah, I see. Yeah.
Was it good?
I didn't see it. I'm going to see it. No, next week. I didn't see it yet.
I
heard good shit about this Mission
Impossible.
I want to
see it. I heard it was really
because
good.
Because who directed it?
Is it the same director?
J.J. Abrams, motherfucker.
Really?
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Now, am I right with that?
I don't know.
What kind of nerd are you? You fucking look like you're fucking at Comic-Con every day, and you know nothing. All you know is about fucking, Tricasters.
Did you watch the scene where Tom Cruise on the plane, behind the scenes?
You mean the scene they've played over and over?
No, they did the behind the scenes.
Yeah.
I thought it was really good.
Well, good for you.
You know what? They tried to bring something to the table.
You know what? Yeah, I wish it was a pizza, fucking wide hips.
Bob, you saw Ant-Man? You saw that?
Body shaming.
I guess I love this dress you're wearing, by the way.
Thank you.
I wish I was cheaper. I only have 60 on me. You brought it down to 60.
How did I become a prostitute? Oh, yeah, because I literally made my price.
I love that you did that.
Ant-Man.
I saw Ant-Man. Keith Roberts and Dante bought 18 tickets each.
Oh, God.
We took over that fucking 85th Street Theater. The seats are too comfortable. Here's the problem with that theater. They're fucking amazing leather recliners.
On Broadway.
Electric recliners, and they lie flat. So you literally can lie flat.
Oh.
Me and Lenny Marcus, my baby girl, sat there. He goes to CVS. We're fucking dating. When we go, me and Lenny are fucking dating. He goes, we going to CVS to get snacks. Do you want snacks? I'm like, I guess. I feel like me and my wife. I'm like, yeah. We go in. What do you want? I want pretzels. He gets pretzels. He gets veggie chips, all these healthy carbohydrates that I eat. And as soon as I eat them, I'm literally fucking 20 minutes in the movie. They have video of me going out.
Was the movie that bad?
Dude, it was bad for me because I'm used to, you know, a regular Marvel movie with, you know, Guardians of the Galaxy, fucking Iron Man, Avengers.
Hold on.
This was very, Ant-Man's a different type of comic book.
It's a heist.
We didn't know what to expect from Guardians of the Galaxy.
I did my origins background, motherfucker. I know you. I know shit about that motherfucker you don't know.
I'm not going why to contest
did he,
that.
Why, when he held the purple stone, did he not die?
Because a purple stone is infinite power.
No. He's half Terran.
Dude, what the fuck would you spoil that for?
Why would I spoil them?
It's movie, way more impressive that Scopo actually knows that.
The movie
it fucking
came out.
Blew me away.
Yeah. It was very impressive.
The fact that, where did you,
I just watched it last
Was that
night.
In the rapper?
I watched it 100 times. Hold on. I remember that.
Explain to me, what's Tehran?
It's.
Okay.
Thanos.
Well, what was his name?
Not Thanos.
Chris Pratt's character.
Yeah.
Star Lord.
Mm-hmm.
His father.
They thought his dad was a human.
Human.
But his dad was Tehran. Scopo read that on the Big League Chew rapper.
You explain the same word with the same word. I'm trying to get the meaning out.
Tehran? Can I explain it for you? He's wrong.
I'm not wrong.
Who's in the chat room?
I'm not wrong.
Please go to the chat room.
We're on a minute delay, so we'll take him a second.
It's okay. Everybody in the chat room, please correct Scopo. He's right, but he's fucking wrong.
No.
You're wrong.
His mom was human. She died of cancer.
You know what Tehran was?
Another planet?
It's what they called Earth.
Okay, well, I'm wrong.
How do you apologize like that?
Here's
like you're right.
He's right.
Okay, I'm wrong.
He is right. His father was from Tehran, and that's just called Earth.
Oh.
Okay? But his father, at the end of the movie, now, only certain powerful beings can hold an Infinity Stone. Now, in Avengers, that was an Infinity Stone. There's five
Vision,
of them.
Vision has one.
Vision has one, right, exactly. So he has this Infinity Stone, and if Tehran held it, you fucking die. But at the end of that movie, he didn't.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So he has some alien shit in him. His father disappeared, supposedly, when he was young. His mother died.
But they hired him to bring back to the father, but they never took him back.
His father hired these guys to take him and bring him to his dad, but they didn't. They just raised him as one of these thieves. He was supposed to bring him back. His father is a fucking supreme being. Mm. Do you understand?
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah, yes.
All right. Was that Mike?
Yeah.
So, anyways.
But you didn't like him at all.
He was right. Well, Ant-Man, what's up, Mike? Ant-Man was... I mean, look, I didn't see it. I fell asleep. It's a goofy movie.
So it started out bad?
It starts out... Look, man, when the guy... Well, look, man, when anybody shrinks into an ant, you giggle. When you see a dude run up to an ant and then jump on its back and see the little ant, you're like, what the fuck is that?
You missed the whole fight. Did you see the fight that happened?
I seen a couple fights, and then I fell
with
asleep.
With him and Falcon? You didn't see
that? I didn't even know Falcon was in the movie. That's how much I slept.
What's your fall asleep rate
don't
in movies?
Don't tell him, because I
don't fall asleep ever in movies.
Really? Okay.
That's but that place, though, if the movie's not really good, you can pass out.
These seats are so comfortable. It's the most comfortable recliner in the world, and it lies flat. And then you carb up with all the carbs that Lenny got me. And then he had little Kit Kat bars. I was out.
It's like why you did it first to yourself? Class.
Why did I did it to myself? I'll tell you why I done it to myself. I had no choice. It was 12:30 at night. You know what I mean? And I'm sitting next to Lenny.
You can't police yourself?
Listen, man, I why don't you police me? How much it cost?
$900. Sorry, fuck Amanda.
Oh, all right, now give
my... My name is not Amanda.
What is it again?
I'm not even going to tell you, and your price just went up to $2,000.
I got that.
$5,000.
I'm going to work an extra week for that.
Now, Mike, she went out of the room and priced us all out. How much it was... Her and her girlfriend, she bangs mostly comedians.
Oh, really?
Mike, he got it.
But Mike's got makeup on now. Looks good.
Yeah, I got makeup on. Fantastic.
So they play a game. How much would it cost to fuck him?
That's funny.
So it's hilarious.
That's good.
She went out of the room. Deepu's 500.
Why? Because he's ethnic?
No, Chris is 250.
I was really the low man of the group, and then Bobby had to throw.
Hang on, shut up, dude. He's fucking.
Just take it.
He's a. What was he?
$900.
$900. He was $10,000.
$10,000?
Exactly.
Good looking guy.
Thank you.
But I know. Hey, he's cocky. I know.
Hey. Oh, you don't like
it. Hey, Queen, not what you'd pay, what she'd pay. You fucking tool.
Why just got here?
What the fuck? You're offended.
I just got here and you turned it around on me?
That's gorgeous.
Tell him your price.
My price.
Holy shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
No.
beat it. Look at Scopo just gets up.
Scopo, this is a bare mic.
Scopo, I'm a good producer. I get my seat up.
Scopo, this is gonna be quick.
Keith, right here. This is gonna be real quick. We're gonna run this podcast and we're leaving.
Wait. She's going around the room. How much it would cost to fuck us? He's $250. Will is $900. Mike is $10,000. Deepu's $500. How much for Voss, Rich Voss?
Greece.
How much?
This is okay.
How much for the flamingo kid?
All right, Voss.
Who's the skirt?
Who's the skirt?
What do you need, a barrel to sing over? Who's the skirt?
Hi, I'm Andrea.
She's a comedian.
Really?
Yes.
How long?
So, 2.5 years and $5,000.
Voss. I like her.
She's good. $5,000.
Okay. He was trying to take me down, like, oh, how long? You know.
Yeah, I like it too.
Oh, it's common words.
How about Mike? How about Vecchione. Mike Vecchione. Now look at that body.
See,
look at that hair.
Pretty though, which is
pretty.
You know,
don't like pretty.
Oh, I don't like it.
Pretty.
Yeah, I don't like pretty. But he has makeup on.
But working class. Can I sell myself?
Yeah.
Working class. All right.
Yeah, give me good bullet points. Like, why are you?
I'm working class, but intelligent. Yeah. I did go to college.
Not too successful.
Almost
made it.
Okay.
I can have you open at a fire hall for me or a Knights of Columbus.
Oh, okay. All right. Spots. All right.
What do you got?
It's like a crystal ball. $600.
Six? Whoa!
That's a lot of money.
Wow. How did I get $5,000?
Because you were in my face.
Okay. And I'm Rich Voss. Right?
Because I know I can get it from you.
How
so
much?
You know.
How much?
Keith Robinson.
Keith, KWR Stupid
right.
Right. Superstar.
It better
how
be
much?
Good.
How much? Now, I'm $200.
Oh wait, I got $200.
I'm willing to
pay
right
her $5,000.
No, she pays to fuck you.
No, I'm not paying. I
mean, you pay her.
Somebody pays her.
It's like the fuck gods.
She fucked me for $2.
And giving me money. It's
so I have $5,000 to fuck you.
Yeah.
I'd step over you to fuck him. Why are you, are you crazy? Who the fuck do you think you're comedy 2.5 years? Shut your mouth open, Mike. I'd rather fuck somebody who's headlining. What the fuck? Listen, why are we up here?
Listen,
now we came here to ruin this podcast. We heard how much to fuck somebody.
Just
I'll tell you how to fuck you. Listen.
Wait, how about Keith? How about Keith?
Huh?
Keith, how much the fuck, Keith? How much the fuck, Keith? Come on.
$150.
Wait a minute! No, wait,
Keith!
Girl.
Shut up, fat boy!
Wow.
First that white whore knows what she's doing. Yeah. She's just trying to get even with daddy.
This is
well, she would have fucked you then.
Huh?
A lump just came out of obscurity.
I like this whole
Miami Vice shirt.
I don't know if you two talking at the same time might make the universe crumble.
Wow. Hanky Sheef. Hanky Sheef. Hanky Sheef.
Hey, I don't think you guys like me, first of all.
Your voice don't work right, man.
I lost my voice.
Did you?
Exactly.
Wow, that and 25 more pounds, you'd be fucking presentable.
Fuck you.
All right, 5,000, relax.
Oh, it's your nickname.
5,000.
He wishes he got paid that on the weekend.
She's coming after
you.
You
want a water, dum dum?
No, I'm going down to
eat. Hey, 5,000. You want a water?
I just stopped up to see this fucking bird that you had up here. You just walked around the cellar going, who wants to do a podcast tonight, right? You had nobody booked.
Yeah.
You had nobody. And tell Scopo to stop calling me. I'm not returning
his
call.
He's right there.
I want to say it to you. I don't want to even talk to him. Can you tell ugly Christian Slater here? Okay.
He's 250, so
yeah. Stop. You're not allowed to talk to me. I'm married to a headliner. What am I trying to say?
Oh, okay. Shit.
She's not.
Where are you from?
Where am I from?
Toots. Yeah.
Toots is from Vancouver in Canada.
Well, I love Vancouver.
I'm a big fan of Vancouver.
Yeah, me too.
The Comedy Mix.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's,
cool,
it's a good club.
My wife's from Canada.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you know his wife, Bonnie McFarlane?
I do. I saw her perform at the Keith and the Girl special this year. She was great.
Yes.
Yeah, very funny. Yeah.
What about Voss?
I've never seen you perform, but
well, you will.
Have you heard of him?
Yeah, I have heard of him.
You've heard of him?
Okay. I'm not going to act like I don't know who he is. I'm not a fucking asshole.
Have you tell the truth and tell the real truth?
Okay, yeah.
Have you ever heard of Keith Robinson?
Yeah.
I mean, besides in this room.
Hold on. See how he turns on you, Keith? Came up as a team.
Yeah.
And this fucking guy.
Yeah. Oh, we're supposed to be a team.
Not only, hey, not only you at the head. Not only you at the back of the bus funny, you're under the bus funny because of him.
Wow.
I got it right here.
Hold on, guys. Every time he bombs, he acts like his voice.
Hold on, man. Maybe can you say that again?
Can you say that again? Kick it.
This podcast is stinking up the joint right now.
I'm telling you.
We can't bear to disturb some shit.
I think that was funny. First of all, it was a fucking slam.
Nothing.
It was a slam on your dumb thing. It was back of the bus funny, and he threw you under the bus. That was two buses.
Now you're going to repeat it. You're going to repeat it.
Beating it to death.
Jesus.
Wait, what's your name?
Mike Brown.
How
Mike
we met?
Black.
You know what? We met about 5 years ago. I brought Rich's CD. I have two of Rich's CDs signed. I break up my weed. Oh, there you go, baby. Fucking bastard.
What a nigger you are.
A what?
Nigger.
A nigger?
What?
I'm a Jew, don't put me in that category. I struggle.
What? Wait, stop. Listen. Listen. This is very expensive equipment.
Everybody relax. Yes. Nagging is like a pickup artist move to like shoot someone down to try to so that you can fuck them.
Okay. Not can you Google that to let them?
It's true.
N-E, not N-I.
I thought he was saying something negative about black people.
No.
Hanky sheef. Hanky sheef.
I'm not giving
him. Hanky what?
He'll put it in one of his suits.
That was good. He rebounded.
One of his Steve Harvey suits.
Picnic cloth shirt. Where did we meet?
Oh, we met at
Hanky sheef. What's a picnic cloth?
Hanky sheef.
On the fucking
picnic. Like the picnic table.
Why you letting this guy get away with these jokes?
Because I'm not giving
him
a hand.
He's
getting
mad.
Will
is
angry.
Will is angry.
Hey, happy?
Voss came in swinging. You got to give him credit.
He always does.
Mike Vecchione is here.
Where did we work?
Yeah, I was getting...
No. I met you at... I was watching you at Gotham.
Oh, okay, cool.
Early before I started.
Dude, that question was not real. He was just talking shit.
Yeah, no, he was, but I wanted to give him respect.
No, but I
want to
fucking say, you know, he's a comic now. I like helping out new comics.
You didn't help anybody.
That's not one comic.
Hang on a second. Keith, I've taken kids on the road with me. I fucking met a middle. I met a... You've done shit. You've never helped me.
You take your wife and your kids on the road. That's it.
Listen to me.
Boss hasn't helped anyone.
Anybody.
Guy,
any one person.
Facebook video. I'm telling you, I fucking take. When I work on the road. You don't know. It's an inside joke with me.
Yeah.
I fucking, every time I go to a new town, I let the locals do guest spots.
I let the locals do it anyways, not on Saturday or Friday.
But is it just you?
These are the
street teams in those towns to help get their shows packed. That's who you give 5 minutes
doesn't
to.
Doesn't pack any
the
shows.
The street team of those towns.
Do you want some Primatine, miss?
Kanky sheep.
Listen, he's got it. Listen, you've never helped.
Tip your middle axe?
I tip everybody.
Okay.
You don't tip your middle axe?
I tip the waiters and waitresses.
You don't tip your middle axe?
I do.
I don't tip my middle axe.
What do you
tip?
Why not?
Because, first of all, they get paid from the club.
Yeah. No, they get paid barely anything.
Here's the fact. You want to tip somebody, tip the fucking host. He makes nothing. The middle guy gets 150 a show. By the end of the
week, he's
doing it.
We need to find anybody that can vouch for
it. I tip the waiters and waitresses for fucking keeping people in check.
I tip the middle axe. That's your wife, idiot.
you fucking Benedict Arnold.
Don't be first.
You fucking returned. That's why you can't do it. That's why you can't do anything with niggers. You can't trust them.
That's what I was saying.
Hold on. Out of anybody here, VOS is the cheapest comedian.
Yes. Oh, you're 100% wrong on that.
No, dude, you don't trip the waist out. They talk shit about you. You don't.
I give them 100% here, so you're 100% wrong.
I tip every waiter and waitress.
I give them 20.
I give them 100% tip on
them. $17.
I asked them. No, you didn't. You have to tell them. First of all, ask them, not ask them.
I tip.
I give fucking. I give major tips.
Not,
that's one
but not on the road, you know.
Yeah, big tips. Major tips.
You old school motherfucker.
Yeah, yes.
I give major tips.
Oh, you are the fucking worst. We were a team.
I give galore tips. Scopo. Fuck Scopo.
What is he doing?
Hey, you leave fucking field hockey hips alone.
I'll
use it twice because my new friends are here. Oh, you fucking lesbo.
He looks like an Argonaut.
What?
Damn it.
You ruin everything.
Huh? You don't know what an Argonaut
is? You tell Fat Ellen to sit back down.
Yeah. I'm back to defending it.
Oh, you have a nice butt, too. It's very full.
Who?
Scopo.
Scopo has a great ass.
Yeah, look
turn
at that.
Turn around, Scopo. Let her see it.
It's
turn around.
Wow.
How much was Scopo?
Turn. Scopo was $250.
$250.
More cushion for the
cushion.
Keith is $150.
Yeah. $150. Keith is $150. Keith
is all his problems?
What problems?
Don't ruin this for him. You were below 1,000. You keep your mouth shut.
Oh, shit.
What's up, Red Eye?
I'm fighting for those dollars.
What's up, Red Eye?
What?
He was on Red Eye.
She shut Mike up. I never seen Mike this quiet.
No, he was on. He just stated a fact.
Obviously, you never done radio with him.
Ah, well, you know what? I'm never coming on your show now, boss. That's how you're gonna treat your guests. We had a discussion about comedy. You're like, I could talk about comedy all day. I'm like, this is successful. And then you talk shit about me afterwards on another podcast.
Ours was a radio show.
I don't like fucking Voss's piccolo hat. Fucking jazz band asshole. Why are you dressing like this? What happened to you?
Nothing. I just like beautiful summer.
He saved his tip money for that shirt.
I want that bad. I like it.
Some comics ad-libbing isn't their skill. Like his set is he kills on stage, but he's not an ad-libber. That's all right. We've known that about him.
Oh, we don't like that.
How'd you get it?
Hey, you didn't like it neither. Nobody here like this shit. He's back.
How'd you get a hat to match your beard? Frankie, like,
and he's your beard, huh? That's a gay joke.
We got it, dum-dum.
Listen.
Listen what? All right.
We got to get out of here.
Pick a subject, any subject. Me and Voss is going to deal with it.
Right now, fucking the killing of the lion.
Fuck
you
that lion.
You know what? First of all, did you?
We'll talk about, first of all, one second. We'll talk about how sucky Ant-Man was when you walked up. That movie sucked.
Ant-Man was pretty bad.
It was
a movie about an Ant-Man. So what are you talking about? What do you want?
He was getting.
You knew what you were getting. A guy talking to ants.
They had a fucking movie about a guy from
Fantastic Four tomorrow?
Yeah, I will. What time?
Ask Johnny Storm here.
How fucking were you saying that one up? Jesus.
That was great. I was in the backpile.
No, people are actually angry that,
What?
Johnny Storm is black.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. People are complaining like he's black.
I wasn't mad that he was black, but he's not black in the comic book.
And? It's a comic book. It's fantasy.
And you say
I don't know.
I mean, I think that when people are, when you love a comic book so much and you want it to keep to its origins, you want it to be what it is when you read it. And all of a sudden they switch it up or make it a girl. And you're like, that's like, why'd you make it a girl?
How did they make it a girl? Huh? When? Give me for instance.
They did Thor. Thor's a girl now.
Thor was a girl. And Ghostbusters.
All the Ghostbusters.
Well, no, I think
it's a girl. Now, people who love Ghostbusters are like, what the fuck? Who love Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd, those characters they created.
Yeah, but it's not a thing about the Beatles. So they don't have a black Beatles. It's a fantasy any damn way.
You know, it works so well, too, with Cedric and Mike.
I mean, it makes more sense that Flame is black. It makes more sense that Flame is black. Because I always wondered why he wasn't, after a little fire, why he wasn't darker.
How about if they did a good time to white people? You wouldn't buy it.
Hold on, let's be honest. Let's be honest. Hollywood didn't make them black because they were trying to, for that diversity. They did it to get attention and get money. To make money. That's it. They don't care about the art.
Yeah, the two white storms stunk.
Fuck you, dude. Chris Evans was great.
He was horrible.
He was good. He was the best one.
No, he wasn't. Fuck.
How are they going to make them? Yeah, how are they going to make them brother and sister?
Fantastic sucked.
Fantastic.
I liked the one with the girl.
What?
You know what? That one with the girl and Captain America. What was he talking about?
The one with the girl.
Yo, who's
there was four of them.
When did you go to the movies the last time?
Was it Avengers?
Oh yeah, that was good.
All is lost. I like the one with the girl.
Yeah,
there was four of them.
Yeah,
her suit was pretty.
I love that she's smashing Voss. It's making me happy.
You know what?
What? 5G.
Go down and get us some coffee.
Pour it right in your crotch.
Oh! A Canadian comeback! Because it's so cold, they poured it. Here's the whole thing with the lion kill. Will Trump stop at nothing? Did you read this today? That Trump said...
Your segue is a masterful.
Pay all the legal bills to this dentist. Did anybody read this online today?
No.
Look at. Do you have a producer that's?
Yeah, we do. Right here. I have him. Okay. Or her.
And then the girl that killed the giraffe is doing TV appearances now. Have you anybody seen this?
Yeah, that bitch.
I'm against the giraffe. So that's just too much. So,
why a lion and a giraffe?
I'm against all of it.
Lions have known to be pieces of shit.
This lion was not a piece of shit.
This lion was not a piece of shit.
It was lying in
your background story reading.
What? I gotta go. I'm never doing a podcast. This is the last time I'll ever do a podcast. I'm in the guys, and you know what? Dude is over.
Background
story checking stuff.
You I like to pay that dentist some money to kill me. There's a god part of the English language.
Do your background story checking stuff. I want to throw up. I got dizzy. Listen, I think it's a big... That lion was actually cool with humans. He was in a protected reserve. They lured him the fuck out. They shot him with an arrow.
Yeah.
They tortured that fucking thing.
For 20 hours.
That thing was friendly to humans. Like, he saw humans as, hey, what's up, guys? I'll be over here doing my lion shit. Take some photos.
So you're scared lying. You're scared lying yesterday, you tomorrow. That's what you're trying to
say. What
are you
saying?
Right?
What was that?
Here's what I...
Hold on. Trump did say he's going to pay... He'll pay the bill for the dentist.
Is that insane?
That's insane. He'll pay the bill and all the legal fees.
That's insane. But at the same time, I don't like
enough money. What is Trump? What the fuck said it?
What is Trump doing? Is he just trying to take votes away from people?
I don't know what that's what
he's doing. He's leading the polls.
He's leading the polls.
He's got to have 23%.
Yeah. And Bush is 17%.
What is this fucking Brewster's Millions? This is nuts that he's leading the polls.
Well, because he's popular. That's the only reason why.
He's what?
He's popular.
I'm sorry.
I said popular.
Get that dentist on the phone. I want Will Hunted at Washington Square Park. And probably beheaded.
How are you the worst talker on a podcast with Rich Voss?
All right, I got to run. Listen, if you two want to use this on your resume that you met me, you can.
Where are you going?
He got nothing to do.
I got
to
eat. I'm
starving. He got nothing to do.
He got nothing to do.
Blood sugar.
The next show is that's in September.
We just... please. That's my next show is September.
Yeah, we looked on your calendar. We actually looked. What restaurant are you at?
Is that Ha Ha Cafe?
Well, I'm doing a theater this Saturday.
Where?
Almost sold out.
Where?
Richfield Playhouse.
Who's where?
Wasn't heard of it?
It's in,
Who else is on the show?
Who else is on?
Me, Bonnie, and Florentine.
And who's the local comics to get into open up?
Who are you helping out?
Huh?
Who are you helping out?
Well, I'm letting the local host and I'm letting the girl do a guest spot up there.
Who, your wife?
What?
I don't know.
Your wife?
My wife is made a fucking movie. She's doing a pilot right now.
The movie
now.
In 2005?
No, the movie that fucking has almost got us our money back. that I just got
almost. Wait, what a success story!
Listen, listen, it is a success story. We're still no, you fucking idiot! Stop!
Hey,
stop.
I almost played Rocky. Almost played Rocky. Won. Rocky almost won in part two.
No, you fucking idiot!
No, no, no! We almost won the war.
It's not even been out a year, and I'm saying we almost got our money.
Well, this movie that almost paid my rent.
It's good. You can, this movie. You can do a play
shut
on words.
Shut
your fucking mouth. Let me tell you. I just got another check for $6,000
today. Almost. Ooh. Almost. Oh, almost.
Yeah, it was $5,888. It was about 160 short of $6,000.
Shit, man.
This fucking movie's on fire. It, oh, whatever.
Is the chat room smoking? What's the chat room doing?
Fuck Yo TV says this podcast should be called Small Bus Funny.
Get out of here.
Oh, God. All right, I'll see you later.
Get out of this joint.
Hey, where's your CD at? Where's your DVD at?
You might, I don't know where the fuck it is.
Come on, man. Where's it at?
What?
Where can they get your DVD?
On KevinHart.com.
Is it at KevinHart.com?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, they just trashed you. They're saying that you're his bitch.
That's not what he said.
Why are you looking at the phone? Why are you looking at the phone? Ain't nothing on the phone. You trying to get away?
What?
You guys want Scopo to help you downstairs? Scopo, make sure they make it down the stairs.
Yeah. Do inventory. Check him, check his pockets because he likes to steal shit.
Oh, man.
What?
I'm telling you. You are killing it. Here's the deal. This Saturday at the Ridgefield Playhouse, come see me, Bonnie, and then Friday I'll be at Bridge Street Live.
And some local favorites.
Bridge Street Live.
What about Florentine?
Florentine's with a Saturday.
Who's headlining?
I am.
You're headlining both shows. Did they want that, or did you just say that's going to happen?
Who can follow me?
Florentine, Bonnie,
the local
me,
the local
Mike, Will, Mike, she could, and Scopo with Deep who could,
the local favorites,
local favorites, my aunt Peggy,
the waiters.
I met a guy at an airport last week that was pretty witty. He could fucking follow you.
Exactly.
Stop thinking, motherfucker. Stop thinking. Get the fuck out of here. Take it. Beat it, Flapjack.
Take it.
Come on, kid. Hit the skids.
Yeah.
Fucking stupid.
Y'all really fucked up this podcast.
What?
What? That was your plan.
What?
Come up
what
here
are you pointing at? What? There's a microphone right there. What?
What's his PlayStation?
That's the remote control. He hooked it up so he changes cameras with the remote control instead of a keyboard.
You don't know much
so
right
we have five camera shoot up here and a 16 camera, a 16, what is
shots. Take your time.
16 shots. And he does it with the remote.
He's got a dreamy set of eyes.
Which one?
This one right here. Look at it, all thick and stuff.
Yo, take the hanky sheaf with
like
you.
He's like a little fucking John Mayer with no talent. Look at him.
Take the hanky sheaf with you.
What are you? Yeah. exactly. Oh, you know what? That's when Keith is finished. Old Keith would have done it and took the hit. Walk those old fucking geriatric motherfuckers downstairs. Holy
nah,
shit. Better
than assholes.
Tell them to take it with
you. Oh, my God. That is just fucking... We're going to blow through the break. We're going right through it. I'm going to read this ad. Where's that ad? Do we have the ad?
You
are behind. Okay. Oh, Jesus, man. All right, real quick. Get the chat room ready. You got something in the chat you want to ask, you want to talk, you want to say something. Anybody in the room that's here or just... Get it going now because we're around 30 seconds behind in there. Hey, check this out. Golf's final major starts next week, and DraftKings is celebrating by giving away $3.3 million in prizes and crowning the year's last fantasy golf millionaire. DraftKings.com is America's favorite one-week fantasy golf site where you could win huge cash prizes every tournament. Just pick six golfers, pile up the points, and pick up your cash. And anyone can do this. Whether you love the game of golf or just want to try a new fantasy sport, you never experience golf like this. With every long drive and made putt bringing you closer to $1 million payday, sports fans just like you have been winning big all year long at DraftKings, including the first three fantasy golf millionaires. You could be next. The next event begins with the tournament, so choose your golfers before next Thursday. Tee off for your last chance at winning $1 million playing fantasy golf at DraftKings this year. Hurry up to DraftKings.com now and use your promo code Kelly to play for free at a shot at becoming a millionaire. That's a millionaire. Enter Kelly now at DraftKings.com. DraftKings.com, that's DraftKings.com. Of course, go to Radcast.com. 17, we're adding a new show very soon that I'm very excited about. We always try to add different shows. We don't add the same thing over and over. A lot of networks keep, you know, seem to just do the same fucking thing. It's like a theme network. We're not like that. We like a variety. We like interesting shows. We like to mix it up for you guys so that when you come to Riotcast, everything is here, is available to you. Sports, you know, women, men, guys, comics, music, whatever the fuck it is. And we're presenting a new show that's coming out, maybe two. I'm very excited. So go to Riotcast.com, check out all the shows, and make sure you support all of us in what we do, stand-up comedy. If you see us anywhere, come to our show, let us know that you heard us on the YKWD. All right, we're back. What do you got in the chat room, Deepu?
Andres Malagon says, Will's teeth look really nice today. There you go. See, nice little positive thing, you know?
That was good that you took something positive.
Patrick Milligan says,
but you took it about your favorite guy. So now we know you don't like me, so what do you have on me?
Jason Jack says, Bobby Kelly is the best comedian I've ever seen.
That's from him. What do you have to say? Thank you, Jason. I'll take that. What else you got?
Stephanie Bazulko says, I'll fuck Mike for 500. Got you beat, Andrea.
That's your choice. Right.
Who's Stephanie?
That's your choice.
That's my girl.
Is that your girl?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Oh, that you this Mike. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. That's your girl.
Yeah, that's my girl.
Oh, your real girlfriend.
Yeah, right.
So she doesn't want to fuck this Mike.
I thought
she wants to fuck that Mike. But that's why your tone was like, that's my girl.
But that's not even cheaper than your price.
What? I'm still 200.
Said, yeah, but she said she'll fuck Mike for 500. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's not
he
even
probably
cheaper.
Owes her money. Yeah, I didn't know you had a girlfriend.
Yeah.
No shit. Yeah.
She came to the barbecue.
I brought her to the barbecue.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you
I
remember.
Forgot.
Yeah. I know. That was a crazy. It was a crazy.
Dude, for me, I don't remember anybody being there.
No, I know.
That was the craziest shit ever, man. Yeah. 3 hours in the rain cooking.
And yeah, it was great, though.
It was a fun time, right?
It really was.
You broke up with your girl, right?
I did. Yeah, we were talking about that before the podcast.
Yeah. Wow. I didn't even know you had a girl.
Congratulations, Deepu.
He didn't know he had a girl.
How long have you been with your girl?
I mean, we dated for about a year and a couple months.
I thought
and,
you would...
Was this arranged?
yes. It almost was.
That's actually a legitimate question.
Yeah. I mean, she is Indian, so that was definitely a big factor in it, you know?
Really?
Oh, yeah, shit. Definitely.
For her or you?
Both of us, for sure.
So your family wants you to marry an Indian?
Absolutely.
Wow.
What if you marry a Puerto Rican? Is that close enough?
It'll take it. They'll definitely have to be like an integration process, for sure.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Would they be pissed if you married me?
You specifically, yeah. But I mean, white girls in general. White girls in general, I think it's a little higher than Puerto Rican.
Why would they be pissed if you?
So wait, where black girls fall on that list?
They prefer that the most. Will. They would love that. No, I'm kidding, of course.
He said, "I'm kidding, of course."
Progressive.
And I'm never gonna work again.
No, you'll work, dude.
You gotta do an apology tomorrow. When
this
is open mic spots.
Well, I mean, culturally, the Indian people want them to marry other Indians, and there is probably maybe a white dude or maybe a light-skinned black kid like Mike with an education. Definitely not a fucking Haitian, a mumbling Haitian. You think in Alaska, one of their family parties? Calm down. It's hot. What is this, chicken? All right, whatever. That was an act out. I don't know.
You really took a risk.
Yeah. I applaud the effort. Like, how do you expect to explain that? Indian marrying a Haitian?
That was pretty good.
Yeah.
Colin, you were saying before that you put up with her.
Yeah, I mean, I thought, like, I would give it a shot because she's Indian, I'm Indian, you know.
But you didn't get along at all?
What's that?
You didn't get along at all?
We had nothing in common, you
know? She didn't blow him.
You was Indian.
What? Oh, what happened?
Blow you?
We talked about that before.
Yeah, Jesus. That was the thing. You know, she wasn't the type.
Wait, is it that Indian girls don't blow? Or
that's
blow
a
lot. You?
No, they. I think she doesn't blow.
Oh.
She watches the vagina monologues a lot. You know, she's that type.
What the fuck does that have to do with anything?
I was making a feminist joke.
Oh God.
Oh wait, that was a joke or that was real?
Why, that was a joke.
You get offended at feminist jokes?
No, it's just like it.
No, that was a joke.
You can like
that was not real.
And still suck dick.
No. That was a joke. She didn't really do that.
We know.
That was an open mic joke.
Yeah.
Tell us the facts, man.
That was the facts. What else do we want to know?
Why did you put up with her for a year and a half?
I mean, we had fun together. You know, we'd fool around, and she was pretty. But, you know, I don't think there was long-term potential in it. That's all.
You fucked
her? You broke up with her?
Yeah, I did.
You fucked her?
Last time I saw you...
Was it good?
We were planning...
It was all right. I mean, it's mostly my fault.
What'd you say?
Last time I saw you, we were planning ways for you to break up with her by just forcing her to break up with you. Like, to be the biggest piece of shit ever.
What did you do?
I mean, I was, like, proposing cheating on her, you know, all the classics, but you were just like... Wow. I'll just
yeah, I mean, you're very free sexually. I just remember when I met you, I was like... The one thing that struck me is you... What the fuck story was it you were telling me? Oh, you were getting fucked in the butt, and you shit on the dude's dick.
Yes. Mm. I projectile
classic
shot everywhere.
Wow. Was that on purpose?
No, well, I...
Yeah.
I put my money's on Indian food.
No, Mexican food.
She's part of the Fantastic Four. That's her power.
You know what, though? I did recently...
What are you going to do now? Oh, motherfucker.
He'll never forget you.
He will never forget me. I recently peed on a guy on purpose during sex. And
why?
In the bed?
Yeah, in the bed.
He requested it?
Yeah. Oh.
What'd he say? Norton say?
Yeah.
What do we all know it is?
He kept mentioning that it's something that he used to do, and I was like, all right, I'm going to...
When you're peeing, was you going...
I wasn't peeing in his mouth. I was peeing on his... Chest.
Torso.
You could pee on command?
Well, I drank like 6 bottles of water. Because the first time
pee? Because you were sipping this pee?
The first time I tried to do it, I got shy. And it was like, it's a lot of pressure. You're like on someone. Yeah. It's like, it's time for you to piss.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it. And then I drank a shit ton of water. And then I just...
So let me
get
this.
Did it smell bad?
No. It didn't smell like anything.
Did you squat? Or how would you position?
I was on top. And then I would kind of like shimmy forward and then
did you
piss.
Use one of those funnels?
No, I just freestyled all
so
over
so
sheets. Yeah.
So it just shot right down in his chest.
Yeah, it went everywhere.
And he was hard. That turned him on.
Yeah, he loved it. It was fucking amazing.
Whose bed was it?
His bed.
Oh. So wait a minute, you liked it too?
Oh yeah.
Really?
It was.
Did
so
you ever
fun.
Get peed on?
No.
Could I?
You
I mean,
get
could,
shit on?
Wait a second. Let's stop.
$250.
How could I? I'm sorry.
Yeah. What would that cost?
No. I don't know the answer now. Would you let your boyfriend pee on you? Would you be into that?
Probably, yeah. Just
in the shower?
No, I mean, you can do it in the bed.
Yeah, but the bed, you're ruining a mattress. Yeah. Apparently, you two have never bought a mattress. Because when you become an adult and it costs $1,800 for a good mattress, I'm not letting my wife piss on me on it. We're going in the shower, and you piss there, and then we clean it up.
Unless you got Bill Gatesman, you just buy another mattress.
No, you can have either get plastic sheets that you
can
buy.
Yeah, you can buy plastic.
Hold on, why do you know?
Why you held your hand?
I just know. I thought it was.
Why did you hold your hand? Like
because this
plastic.
Is what you put. You, this is how you
he's
put
a common
on
man.
A bed.
That's how he fucking repairs shit. He's done this his whole life. Sheetrock, windows, doors, fucking pee pads.
It's called being a problem solver.
Pads. Yeah.
Because pee in the shower, that's kind of predictable, and it kind of takes the...
yeah, it's...
Hold on. Mike,
stop.
You've been peed on.
In the ocean.
No. You've
in the ocean.
You've peed on somebody.
In the ocean.
No,
it was a mutual thing in the ocean.
You've peed on somebody sexually.
Mike.
Well, did you like it? Did you like it?
Mike, why are you holding out?
I'm not holding out. I'm talking. I don't like to be pushed, Will. Especially by somebody from
He's
the third
pusher,
world. I'm telling
yeah.
you. I don't care for it.
Third? Deepu's third. He's Hey, you've been peed on.
In the ocean.
Have you ever peed on somebody?
We did it simultaneously.
Say the ocean,
in the ocean.
Again. I'm fucking
We did it simultaneously in the ocean.
The ocean doesn't count, you fuck.
Were you standing like knee deep and you let the pee go on you and then you submerge or you're just both submerged?
Both submerged.
Well, that's just like peeing in a bathtub.
Just say no.
What the hell is Mike talking about?
I'm sorry that my story wasn't good enough for you. You asked me to be honest, and then you shit on my honesty. Is this going to get people to open up? more? Is it? I mean, I don't know. I'm asking a real question.
And kidding.
That was beautiful.
Mike can't get mad because he has dimples.
And makeup.
How can I open up if you're just going to shit on me?
Now, you just went up to 400.
That's fine.
Oh, this is the funniest show I've ever been on. Listen to me. So, Mike, have you ever peed on somebody?
No, can't do the pee.
You been peed on?
I've done.
Yes.
I've done the anal pulled out with the pool.
You had shit on your dick?
That's accidental, though. That's accidental. To me.
Wait, what happened? So
that happened to me, too.
What happened again?
I was having anal sex with this girl, and I pulled out, and it was just a mess.
What do you mean a mess?
Like shit
on your dick.
Like Hershey's chocolate on your
condom.
Here's
the deal. And it's I don't want shit on my dick.
Yeah, but you don't blame the girl for that.
You can't.
Yeah,
who do you blame? Who do you blame?
No, you take one on the chin.
Yeah.
How about
not eat so much?
Mike's been peed on and shitted on. She's going to give you the gift of her ass and then you're going to fucking complain.
How's this? You didn't eat dessert and you didn't need that fucking appetizer. Have a salad. Settle down. If I'm going to stick my fucking dick in your bum. All right?
You're doing her a favor?
Settle down. Wash your ass out.
Have a salad and settle down.
Yeah, settle down. I don't need fucking shit on my dick because you're a fucking, you can't stop at a buffet in Vegas. All right? That's disgusting.
So when you shit on that guy, did you plan that?
No, it was a Tinder hookup. And
Wow. Did he rate you after?
five brown stars, baby. And he was drunk, and I just started being sober, and I ordered food because I thought that would be cool to like have food because he was coming over, and I had Mexican food because I'm a fucking idiot.
You ate Mexican food from where? Like from Brooklyn? Like,
yeah, some like Brooklyn late
like a
night
truck?
Bullshit. Yeah.
Yeah, with real Mexicans.
Yeah, real Mexicans.
Right.
Yeah.
There's no Dan Soder as a waiter.
No.
Hey guys, can I get you some of our avocado dip?
No one was making the guacamole in front of me. It was from a bag.
So wait. Did you plan on this anal sex?
No, but
so then you had Mexican food. You didn't expect anal.
Yeah. I'm always banking on anal, but if it's coming, then you gotta try to go with it.
It's not part of like the normal rotation. Like you're not like you.
I'm not like Wednesday's anal and then Friday.
So wait. How long since you ate the food and you guys had sex? How long time passed? How much time passed?
15 minutes.
So he really went right through him. I mean, right through you.
Right through me, and then right on him.
So he was basically fucking sticking his dick in your egg sandwich from this morning.
Yeah,
it was.
Right, and then he went through like fucking the lunch, some sushi, some ball sushi.
There's a feeling when you're having anal sex, like you think you're going to shit yourself.
Yeah, that's called a dick in your ass.
Most of the time, I don't know if you guys know about having dicks in your ass, but there's a feeling like you're going to shit. Most of the time, you're not.
Yeah.
And you just work through it.
Yeah.
But I called it wrong.
You pulled an audible.
That's great.
Did you do a warning? You did a warning before?
No, as soon as the button is pressed, you're fucked. You're done. God.
And you know what?
So did you finish?
In a way, kind of.
Where was it? Your place or his place?
My place.
Oh. Was it your place? You just leave.
Yeah.
His place.
His place, yeah.
So after you did that, did he get up and leave or did y'all stay and talk?
No, we took a shower together.
Yeah. Got back in the game.
And then I changed the sheets and I put him to bed because he was wasted and I was sober.
He smelled like shit.
And then smelled like my shit. And then I sat on the toilet for a while because my intestines really hurt. This is really gross. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
No.
So,
did it sound like somebody was puking out of your asshole?
My intestines were still fucked up from the
shit.
Yeah. And so I was like having diarrhea, but I couldn't. I was afraid that he would hear the sound.
Yeah.
So
throw up again.
Yeah. And I heard this.
Wake up in horror. She's shitting again. No, I don't want to fuck your ass.
Like a numb. And so
there's your $500.
I've heard that you can like cover your asshole like a trumpet with toilet paper to like stop the air sound.
Do you believe everything you read on Facebook?
I can't believe you shit on a guy and then were embarrassed that he would hear the sound.
I know. Well, I'm a fucking chick. You're so no.
She said she was pissed drunk.
I love that she went to Gizmodo and found how to silence your asshole.
It's like
how
a
to make a silencer for your asshole.
A friend of mine told me this. She's like, if you're on a trip with a guy and you got a shit, you just put it a toilet, you wad it up and you put it against your asshole to mitigate the sound.
but it was
it's
coming
like a bullet
out
with a pillow.
Yeah, and you exactly, and it but it was coming out so fast. I was just shitting on my own hand and then rinsing my hand off. for like hours. It was like, and he was,
oh my god,
he was passed the fuck out, and I was like, this is just my life.
Of course,
life.
He was pretending to be passed out because he wanted. If you go, can you help me?
I'll fucking help you. I need to go to the hospital.
That would have been great if you would have shit on his dick and then just went back to eating Mexican food.
Yeah.
Right after that. Just like leftovers. You're a fucking soldier.
God, what a
good
nightmare.
Shitty story.
Yeah, it was awful.
What a fucking
how long
nightmare.
Ago was this?
Is it last week.
That's right. No, it was about a year ago. Yeah.
And have you seen... seen him?
No, we actually kind of dated for like a few
after
months.
After that?
Yeah.
After that?
Wow.
And this guy's a comic?
He's
did
not, he, this not a comic.
Did he remember it?
Yeah, he remembered
it. Of course
it.
He would. How would you... Passed out, you passed out that? Drunk. Yeah.
You remember that.
You could forget.
Yeah. You remember
passed out drunk. He'd be blackout.
I'm a fun fucking girl. What can I say?
Well, I don't know if fun.
What happened?
You're a lot of work. You're a lot of work.
Why you guys didn't continue? What happened?
You're like owning a new puppy. You get a penny can around you so you don't shit on my dick. No.
Why you guys break up? Why you guys didn't continue the relationship?
Shit on his dick. He wasn't going to marry her ever.
Hey kids, here's a good story. When I first met your mom, she shit on my dick. And then she had diarrhea for an hour and just kept shitting on her own hand. She thought I was asleep, but I was in the other room. I was throwing up out the window.
You shit like your mother.
Daddy, Daddy, why did you marry her?
Because, I don't know, son. Once somebody shits on you, there's just a connection you make.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
God. Was it fucking smelly poo or was it just...
It was
he's laughing his own thing.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you this because you laughed at it.
it was grainy and watery.
Wow. Really?
Oh. Yeah.
Really?
It was like viscous.
Did
kind
it stink?
Yeah. Not as much as you would think it would. Yeah.
So you dated him for a while.
Yeah.
That's pretty epic.
Yeah, it was
cool. And it never happened again.
No.
You're very
learn.
Hold
learn.
On a second. Anal didn't happen again?
No, anal happened again, oh. But I didn't
you know. Definitely broke up with him.
Projectile.
He fucked it like this. Get a close to that. We good?
This is a safe word.
You broke up with him, I'm assuming. There's no way he's breaking up with you.
Why?
Like a, yeah.
I mean, he survived the fucking getting shit on.
It was like a mutual. It was mutual. He moved.
That shit don't exist.
He moved to Chicago, and it was like we were just. It was kind of a stupid relationship, so I was like, all
right. Hey, cool. So did you guys ever have any other incidents with that at all?
Oh, you're getting so like sexual.
Why your voice?
Tell me about your incidents.
Hey, Jim.
Can I ask a question? Did he have a condom on?
Yeah.
Yeah. For anal?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah,
because that might
what?
Happen.
AIDS. Dude,
and also AIDS.
Fucking the ass.
Also AIDS.
Yeah, what are you fucking mad at?
You gotta
use
an
anal without a condom?
If you're gonna anal without a condom? If you
I have, yeah, but my girlfriend.
Christopher, look at me.
Don't even matter.
If you're gonna fucking use a condom, that's when you use
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's...
Just lube up.
No, dude.
No,
when you, the asshole, it gets cut easy. Blood, it's very sensitive skin. And when you put your fucking big lesbian helmet in some chick's asshole, you're gonna tear it a little bit. You're going to get blood, and you get blood. That's how you get AIDS, man.
Yeah.
That's how you get disease.
What if they don't have AIDS?
How do you know that?
Do you?
Yeah. You have the dumbest.
Because I'm not going to fuck a random.
Yeah,
I'm not going to fuck a random girl in the ass.
It doesn't.
Well, they met on Tinder that same day.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I party.
Still using a condom, bro.
I didn't think about that. All right, relax, Harris.
I mean,
worried
about
fucking not sex ed over here.
Hey man, we'll try. Yeah, it is. Actually,
we're worried.
Yeah.
I'm not fucking a random girl in the ass.
No, but I think that's kind of tough to pull off with a condom. I think.
What is anal sex?
With a condom, yeah.
I don't think so. Not if that girl's asshole's big enough. Right on. What's up?
Yep.
I think
that was so cheesy.
Give me the towel thing.
Here's the thing. If a girl likes it in the ass, her ass is ready to get a dick in it.
Yeah.
Okay? It's not like the first time anal, yes. Very hard to do. Probably easier to do with just a raw dick. Maybe put your helmet in a couple times. But a chick who's took it in the butt a couple times, likes a little anal. It's not that hard to fucking get in there, and you know, you get a little lube, you're good to go. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
Why are you mad? Why are you
I'm not mad. It's just, I don't know. I mean, I hear what you're saying. Maybe it's just, it just doesn't. I don't know.
What? Which, why are you sad?
I'm sad by it. I'm thinking about
aggressive
it.
About the
I'm thinking about it.
Have you ever fucked somebody in the ass, Will, with that monster cock?
I tried. You shouldn't be allowed to.
It couldn't go in.
What girl
who said she claimed she loved anal, and then I thought it was my first time doing anal.
Right.
It couldn't go in, and we tried for 20-25 minutes, and then my dick just started losing.
Is there a lot of time you can't fuck a girl because your dick's too big?
How big is
it's
your dick?
It's not that
what
big.
Is
it's can not
Will, stop for one second. Yeah.
Here we go.
Can we please show her your dick?
It's not that big.
Show your dick.
It's
yeah, okay.
Hang on, stop.
When you show her the dick, please close your eyes. Okay. He's going to get the thing, mm-hmm. and I'll tell you to open it. Mike will hold it in front of you.
Okay.
I just need to get your natural response. Mm-hmm. Your like, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
All right, tell me when you got it.
Picking it up is not that.
Tell me when. Tell me you got it. All right.
Yeah, for an avatar.
Everybody, calm down.
Calm down.
And
calm
also
down,
price adjustments.
I really do get excited when Will takes his dick pic out.
He took it out the cellar a couple weeks ago.
Am I gonna do the drum roll or somebody else?
I can do it. I'm banned. Boom, ba damn, boom, ba sex and drugs. And okay, now wait. Hold it up to her. Mm-hmm. Hold it up to her face. Okay.
That's what she said.
No, a little up further so she can see it. Okay, open your eyes.
Whoa!
That's big, right?
That's big.
Any price adjustment on that 900 form?
No.
Do you need to zoom in with your
fingers? Wow!
Someone to try to test.
That is zoom like out. Halfway down your leg.
Yeah.
Wow.
What would you do with that?
I don't want to fuck with that.
You
I don't
want
right?
to
die.
That's pretty crazy, man. Well,
yeah.
Wow.
That's a
Mike,
that's
have you ever done the bum?
That's insane. I caught a peripheral. I wasn't trying to look at it. I caught a peripheral.
It's insane.
And it's insane.
It's insane.
It's insane. You shouldn't be proud of that.
Yeah. So is there anything
it's
proud
a little
of it?
Do
girls say like no to you?
Ashamed
when
of
a dick's that big, sometimes you're like, whoa, I don't even know if I can take that.
Yeah. Do girls ever say no? Like
his dick was so big, it caught my peripheral.
Yeah.
It was so big.
Thank you, Mike.
Mike's fucked up. Mike, are you all right, dude?
Holy shit.
He's like hurt emotionally.
No, it's like really.
It's like coming back from the war. Yeah. I've seen some shit, man.
Shit.
Have you ever did anal?
Yeah.
You did anal?
You know it? He did by his answers before.
Yeah, but no condom, though.
Yeah, no condom. A girlfriend.
That's why.
You like it?
So, yeah.
You did?
I like it.
A little bit off.
It's okay. It's not. It's
do
not.
Do you have shit on your dick?
It's not.
Yeah,
I have. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It doesn't skeevy. You got to know that going in.
Yeah,
you gotta know what's going on.
It's the risk.
It is what it is.
You
she's a person. She's a human being, man.
Whose idea was it?
His.
I think that's a mutual thing. That's a talk you gotta have.
Really?
And then it's
somebody brings it up, Mike.
You talked or you like them onto it?
No. I don't. I just don't go in there.
Okay.
We talk about it.
Okay,
before.
Cool.
He's
respectable.
Yeah, Marissa.
Yeah. You know,
he's a common guy.
With that dick, you have to have a big conversation.
Yeah.
Before you start trying to work that thing in any
for a fucking vagina, you have to have a conversation.
Yeah.
Unless it's a baby elephant.
Yeah, you got to have a plan of attack, like a 6-month plan.
Yeah.
I've fucked in the butt before, but it's always, most of the time, it's been in the heat of passion. Where you're fucking, and you're playing with her butt while you're fucking her, and then you kind of rub around it, and then you kind of pop that helmet in her butt. She's, she does that little grind, like that little fucking, oh, you fucking dirty pig. And then to push it in, and she's like, yeah. And then take it out, and put it in, you know what I mean? And then it's in her butt. But I've never fucked a chick totally in her asshole. Like, I'm fucking your ass. It's always been in the heat of passion when the asshole's all wet up and I've been rubbing it for a while, licking her pussy, and the pussy juice has been dripping in her butt and sweating, rubbing her ass, and then, you know, pop it in a little bit, you know what I mean? I've never said, well, one girl I did. I fucked two girls in the ass, and I didn't know, I was trying to fuck their pussy.
That happened to me.
I did this when I was around 25, mm-hmm. early in my comedy career, Hot Bobby. I remember
Sexy Bobby.
I fucking met this middle-aged woman. She was like 38. Still smoking, though, in a dress at a show. Took her back to my place when I lived with the mentally retarded guys. And I had a water bed. And I remember I was a little fucking weary because she had nylons on. And it was like the summer. I was like, I don't trust chicks with nylons in the summer.
That sucks that shit in.
That's weird, man. Yeah. So then I remember I this is my thing. This was my game. I'd take a chick back to my house, my apartment, and I'd just get naked. And they'd be like, what are you doing? But I was so in shape. And, you know, I was so, you know what I mean? I was so confident. I was like, this is my place. What's wrong? And it worked. Every fucking time.
Great.
I remember I go on, I started fucking, and I'm like, yeah, you like that? It was all wet and mushy. I was like, you fucking, she goes, I love it in my ass. I was like, it's in your ass? I was like, yeah. I, I got all grossed out, because you know me, I was like,
you get naked with soft or erect?
I got naked hanging.
I make sure it's
hanging. What's
three
hanging
quarters? Yeah, three quarters.
Oh, okay.
That's a balls confident move,
that's
dude.
That's a real.
It was super confident.
It was my move, man. I take him back to my house.
That's a good move.
But here's the deal. We'd already kissed in the parking lot.
Yeah.
We kissed in front of my house.
Yeah, you know what
you're
doing.
Got inside the room, made the fuck out, rubbed the pussy, rubbed the titties, made out, and then I just take my clothes off.
Oh, like, would you go into another room and then come out naked, or just do it right there to be like,
we thought you just come in the house and you just start undressing yourself.
You say, hey, make yourself comfortable.
You're like,
calm
down,
how sexy was sexy Bobby?
Calm down.
You left a lot of details out, man.
Calm down.
It worked every time.
I would fucking, we kiss some shit, we get a little going, get her riled up, and then I just take my clothes off. And she's like, and she'd be sitting there like, what the fuck are you doing? And I'd be like, I'm getting naked. This is my room. This is my place. And she'd be like, you can't just get... I'd be like, hey, you can get naked too, but this is my room. I feel comfortable. And then I go over to her.
You didn't say leave. You didn't say leave, though.
This is my room.
He didn't say leave, though. He didn't give her the option.
Yeah.
Neither did Kobe.
So then I'd walk over.
Cosby.
I'd walk over naked, start kissing them again. And then they'd just grab your shit and you'd be fucking.
Bobby, I know dudes that really did that with no kissing. Girl walked in the freaking hotel.
Everybody has their own style. My style was kissing first.
And they take their clothes off and they're like, what's up? Are we going to waste time or not?
Yeah.
And then sometimes the girls leave, sometimes the girls stay.
Are we going to waste time or not?
Yeah, that's what the guy said.
My kissing would prevent that waste time. I would kiss them. They'd be like, oh, this is great. And I'd stop right mid-kiss, take my clothes off. They're like, what the fuck? We were just having my pussies went, this is, I was really like into it. And you'd get, what the fuck are you doing? And now I'm naked. And I'd be like, what? And then I'd walk over and kiss them again. And it's done. So all you have to do is get naked too, and we're fucking.
Can you do that today?
Huh? I could do that today with an elderly woman. If I met a hoary, slutty, like 58-year-old woman from Algeria, I think I could do that. Or I could give her $1,000 and she'd do it. Oh, fuck me, dude. I just don't like. I think anal sex is. It's the hottest shit in the world, but I always felt bad after it. I always felt like I fucked up. I always felt like I did something dirty.
It's a little grimy.
Yeah, it's a little like, ah, shit. Now it's in my dick hole. You know what I mean? I started thinking about that movie Chris Rock did, that animated film. What's that? Where he was like a fucking algae or some shit.
Osmosis Jones?
Yeah. I started thinking about all the, you know, just all that fucking Osmosis Jones shit so in my dick.
You're doing that, and then you're thinking about bacteria.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, dude, does anybody have a microscope?
Yeah.
Look at my,
yeah, I got
my
fucking
hole in my dick.
My dick is that Play-Doh thing, and you just, ugh. The other time I had poop on my dick was when I got a massage lady started sucking my dick, and I got carried away, and I jumped off the table and just stuck it in her pooper by accident.
Wait, what?
Just stuck it?
Yeah, she,
no, hold on. You're getting a massage.
Yep.
It's
a massage. I don't know what he said. But
you're not even kissing her. She's massaging
she's
you.
She's massaging me, yeah.
You're paying her to massage you.
Yes.
You get a hard on, you jump up, and you...
Well, no,
she
started
sucking
my dick.
She was sucking his dick. She
started sucking my dick. So
yeah, he's not a savage, Will.
I just jumped up, and I bent her over the thing, and I started fucking her in the butt.
Why?
Because I just... Fucking, I don't know why. Why did she suck my dick?
Was the vagina missing? Suck your dick? Why did she suck your dick?
Because she wanted to suck my dick.
Oh, you were sexy Bobby. You were sexy Bobby at this. Okay.
What? It's just the end of the moment.
Yeah, she wants to suck my dick. Yeah. So I bent her over the thing. I started fucking her in the butt. And as I was fucking her, I could smell it. You know, so it went in, and I smelled something, and then went in again. It smelled something. Well, I'm going to throw up right now. And then went again, I could smell it real bad. The last, the third pullout, had just shit. And I was like, and I had to go take a shower. She's like, I'm sorry.
That an option? The vagina was missing? Why you chose the vagina? There's a vagina right there. Why do you chose that one? I'm curious.
Yeah, it's first.
You don't want to get her pregnant, maybe.
I fucked up.
Sometimes it just calls for
I didn't. I was in her butt, and I thought it was a pussy. I didn't.
You confused.
And I told you, I did that a couple times where I stuck it in a chick's butt, and I thought it was the pussy because it just went right the fuck in.
How big?
Straight?
How big?
Straight.
How big God. Are that butt, or how small is your dick?
I think it's a combination.
Two ships passing.
Spoken like a true politician.
I would have to say
combination of factors.
Not too small, but her asshole's not too big, but just right for my dick to go in, like Ant-Man.
Perfect storm.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
It's a fucking weird. It's weird, man. Sex can get grimy and gritty, like peeing on somebody. I always kind of wanted to piss on a chick.
It's so fun. You're allowed to pee on something. When else can you do that?
Okay.
Jellyfish thing?
Yeah, but...
The cleanup work is a good point, though.
Yeah, but if you do it in the shower, it's not a big deal.
Yeah, but that takes all of the fun out of it. It's like...
Right, you just said you peed in the ocean.
Yeah, but that was...
That's God's shower.
I take that better than a shower. Shower is so .
It's a power thing. You're pissing on someone else.
So you like pissing on somebody because that makes you power.
Oh,
how much would it cost for you to piss on me?
$25.
Spot pay.
I'm going to have you piss on me on this table. And I want you to sign the table.
Okay.
You know what's more shit?
You know what's more power than pissing on somebody?
Huh?
Shitting on somebody.
Would you shit on somebody?
She did.
I did.
No, I mean
squat.
On purpose, squat.
You know what? Probably not because it's a lot. It takes longer to shit on something.
Just eat that Mexican food.
Yeah, I don't know. The peeing because you can come and pee and come and pee.
You come and pee?
Yeah, I would squirt and pee and squirt and it was amazing.
Wow.
Now I am. I wasn't before, but now that
I hope Norton doesn't hear this podcast. He's gonna hunt you down like a fucking lion.
It's a new chapter.
He just made a good point. Squirt pee?
No.
I've read something on one of these feminist sites.
Oh, yeah? One of these feminist websites?
Yeah, I don't know which one. There's so many.
Jezebel?
I think it was Jezebel. Where they were talking about squirting is actually partially like urine or whatever.
Well, because I was reading, because I was so nervous and I was getting antsy about doing it. And so I read more about it. It's you just have to let go.
Yeah.
And a lot of women don't come because they're afraid they're going to pee. That's a common feeling. Oh. Mm-hmm. So if you know you're going to fucking pee,
just
it's a lot
it
easier for you to just come and just, you know. Cause
women don't come because they think they're going to pee?
Yeah, a lot of the time. You're like, ooh, I'm
what
I'm
the fuck did you just say? Why did you just turn into an infant? I had to contact that they think they're going to pee. Slow down. We got plenty of time. You have to rush your senses.
I never heard of that. Women don't come because they think they're going to pee.
Sometimes.
I've heard of that. I've heard it.
Yeah, sometimes.
You've never had sex with a woman and heard that? Like, you having sex and she's like, oh my God, I'm going to pee. You've never heard that?
I don't even know.
Has anybody else heard that?
I've heard it.
You've heard it, Mike.
Not during sex, but I've heard it.
You've heard it. Okay.
You're sitting there and you're like, this could get, I'm on the precipice of something and it could be pee and I don't know this person.
Yeah, I've had a girl like stops up, I have to pee. And then they go to the bathroom, oh no, I don't have to pee. And it's pressing against a bladder. I don't know what it is, but you're pressing against
it.
I never liked when girls squirted when I was younger, but now I kind of like.
Wait, you had girls squirted back then?
I'm sorry, what did you say?
You're just making me look bad. You heard me.
No, it's not me. I swear to God, you.
It ain't me.
I swear to God. Yes. I don't know what you said.
You had girls squirted back then.
Squirted. I had girls squirted.
No, I like Will's using the past tense in the present.
It happened in the past.
It didn't happen in the past.
But how much?
It would be girls.
Back then, they used to squirt.
It would be girls squirted on you?
Yeah.
Question mark?
Yeah. It sounds like an assassination.
But don't say the question mark.
You had to squirt.
I do the question mark.
You had.
I want to give this podcast to you. I want you to have it. I want
back
you to have one.
We
can
take.
Back I
in
want
the
you
days.
Can have Deepu, and you can have Chris.
Back in the
women
days,
squirted on
women
you.
Women squirted on you.
Yes, I had the first sexual experience I had. One of the first ones, the first major.
What age?
I was probably 13.
You fucked at 13?
Hang on, I fucked earlier than that. Fucked at 10.
Sexy Bobby.
Okay. But I didn't know what I was doing. Don't get me. I'm out there banging. What's up, girls? I didn't have a watch on, and you know, I was fucking. You know, it was terrible. I shouldn't have done it. But all my friends, there was this girl, Carrie, this local chick,
Squirty Carrie,
big titties. She was in her 30s or some shit.
And you how old? 13.
I was 13.
That's a pedophile.
There was a bunch of other people. No, there was a bunch of other guys there, like five.
She's a pedophile.
Hang on, man. Let me finish.
What are you, the cops? Let him tell a story.
Thank you, Michael. And they would. She would blow us kids, and fuck. And I didn't know what I was doing. I was just trying to fit in. And they'd be like, "Dude, go fuck her, go fuck her." And I went. We're on this bus, and I went to go fuck her. And I put my dick in, like, last.
Wasn't this the slow
and
chick?
She was, yeah, I don't think she was slow. I think she was, I don't know, crazy, mentally unstable.
Well, she was 30, fucking 13-year-old, so.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. I was fucking, you know, I didn't know what I was doing either. But I remember I stuck it in, and she like, discharged. Wow. Yeah, all the water came out on my dick.
She gave birth on
and
your
I,
dick.
And I was so fucking appalled. That's a lot. I was so in shock. It fucked me up for a long time.
That's a lot, like, for 13. Sexual. Yeah.
Oh, mama.
This was like, everybody was taking turns, or it was like one after
yeah.
the other?
Yeah, one after the other.
That's
and it was gross, man. And I didn't, but I had no choice. They would do it. You know, that was in that.
Yeah.
I was pushed into a lot of sexual shit. You know, that's why I'm so, I cry when I think of my son now, because I know so much of what not to do. I don't know what to do all the time, but I know so much of what not to do to this kid because of what was done to me. You know what I mean? I have so much, so many times, so much sexual stuff that was presented to me. So many times that I did stuff that just fucking, I didn't know. Some of it was just plain normal. And I carried around with me because of religion or what other people said. Guilt for so fucking long, and I just felt fucked. And then when I finally had to fit in with these guys, because I did whatever the fuck they wanted me to do, even though I felt bad about it and I didn't feel good about doing any of the shit. So I had a lot of fuck. That's why now sex with me, it's taken me into my 40s to kind of get a hold of it, because sex became something that I did. You understand, I got sober. I didn't know how to pick up a chick. Mm-hmm. I didn't know how to make out with chicks. I was talking to chicks about God. You know, I got sober when I was 15. At 16, you know, I was going to meetings. 17, I remember talking to this chick when I moved to this new neighborhood. And she was like, hey, you know, you're new and blah. She liked me because I was a good-looking kid. But then I was like, yeah, man, you know, it's new, but it's hard. But I talk to, you know, I get my higher power, and every day I say the serenity prayer because, you know, because it's Ryan his will, up. Not mine. And she's like, what the fuck?
It's got to go.
It was bad.
Shit right up, yeah.
And then I met this guy, Mark Caesar, at a meeting. And I remember I'm sitting there. The guy says, you want to fucking make friends, go to a meeting far enough away from your house and don't get a ride home. Mm. So you have to meet people. You ain't coming home. So that's what I did. I went to this meeting. It was a young people's meeting at a hospital that I went to when I was in rehab a couple times. And I actually in juvie jail. And then I went in, this kid there. He walked in. I'm like, hey, can you give me a ride home? He goes, no. I was like, fucking what? I started getting scared. Then all of a sudden, this other kid, hey, I'm new. Can you go? I said, no, I can't do it. I was like, oh, fuck, I'm fucked. Then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, this dude, fucking long hair, ripped T-shirt, fucking tight jeans, boots, bracelets, rocker, comes fucking bouncing in. And I remember I was in juvie hall and he did a meeting. I go, hey, dude, I remember you from Shelter Kid. Can you give me a ride home? He goes, fuck yeah, dude. I'll be right back. He went over to the piano, started playing piano. Three blonde fucking chicks just went over to him, titties hanging out.
How many hot chicks are in AA?
Dude, Jesus Christ.
A lot of hot chicks. About to throw a
lot of hot chicks, man. A lot of hot chicks. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. I went to Bennigan's that night, talked to chicks. He taught me how to pick up chicks again. Good. He fucking schooled me on how to. He goes, dude, you got to reverse the blue balls. Chicks get blue balls too.
How old
he goes,
is he?
Just reverse how old is it. He was 18.
And you was 15?
I was 17. He was 18, 19. I was 17. He was just, he taught me. He goes, dude, just keep making out with them. Graze their pussy. Just don't touch it. Keep grazing it until mm-hmm. they fucking, until when you touch it, they go, oh, just what they do to you with your dick. Do that with their mm-hmm. pussy. And then right when you got them, around 20, 30 minutes in, you put your finger in it and then take it out. And she's going to lose her fucking mind. Guarantee she's going to rip your dick out and just swallow it. And I was like, all right. And I did it, and it fucking worked. This guy taught me how to fuck again. It was crazy. Crazy.
Where is he now?
He's dead. No, he's in fucking Miami, dude, with a smoking hot fucking Spanish. I'm talking Spain. Fucking
oh, that's
rich,
the real Spanish. Yeah.
Gorgeous pure wife, cut. Gorgeous kids.
They look down on the Puerto Ricans.
Tons of money. Family's loaded. Nice. Yeah, he was in a band. He was fucking singer. Went to Berkeley. Fucking great, dude. It was yeah, I learned from that kid. Taught me a lot of shit, man. A lot of shit. Mm. Yeah, and then I met a chick and she broke my heart. I met this chick. I fell in love with her.
What was her name?
Her name was Kristen.
What age?
Oh, never trust a Kristen. Kristen. Or a Crystal.
How old were you?
Either or.
I had to be 19, 20.
How'd she break your heart?
I met her at Grossman's Bargain Outlet. I worked in the lumber yards, flat stacking the lumber.
So you can't talk neither.
That's because it's rubbing off. And she was engaged. She started working there one day, and she
you
came in.
Up?
Hang on one second.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Well, she came in. This is back in the. In
You're an asshole for that one.
Well, yeah. I saved him and me. I was a conduit from God later on, let me tell you. I remember we hooked up. This is how I got her. I mean,
you brought into the room.
My mom made American chop suey. American chop suey, and I had it in my container. And I went, you want some American chop suey? I took her upstairs to the fucking workroom. And my mom's American chop suey was good.
The guy bought me a bagel once, and that's how he got me.
Yeah, food, man.
So good.
So you knew she was engaged?
Knew you wasn't shit. You wasn't shit.
She
then.
Liked me, though, man, from the second she saw me.
How did she break your heart?
We hooked up that day. Made out after the American chop suey. I just started kissing her. I said, meet me tonight. Here's my number. She met me. I took her to this spot by the ocean where there was this wall and the waves would come crash over the wall, over the car. So it was kind of like this fucking sexy, like, water world shit. You know what I mean? Like, and I took her there and I ate her ass out. Mm. She never had her ass eaten. So I was eating her pussy and then I just started fucking sucking on her asshole and she lost her mind. I was just a dirty motherfucker. And that was it. Me and her were fucking boyfriend and girlfriend after that.
While she was engaged.
Broke it off.
Right after the ass eating.
Week later, told her, I'm out. I can't do it. We started dating. Here's the trick. 2 years later, man, I remember we weren't fucking anymore. We got fat. We joined karate together. But then we started going to this buffet across the street. Instead, I remember we just started eating.
Typical Bobby Kelly story.
Right? It's true. I remember. We used to fuck all the time. And then I remember she, we started getting tuna melts.
You know the kind of food? You remember the kind of food?
We started getting tuna melts. You ever have a tuna melt?
Yeah, I had a tuna melt.
We started getting tuna melts and pizzas, and we'd go to this tree where we used to fuck, and we'd eat tuna melts and pizzas and take naps. And we used to fall asleep like two fatties under a tree. And then she went to college. And one day I found this number, Steve, in her pocket. I talked about this before, right?
Probably a business major.
I found it. It said Steve.
Just found
the number. Here I am in college, going to college. I'm starting to...
get fat?
No. I am fat. I'm starting to get fat, but I'm airbrushing now. I'm doing art.
Okay.
she's going to college. She goes, can you please make me all my sorority girls sweatshirts?
Oh, and she's a sorority girl, too.
Oh, so I made all these sorority shirts.
Oh, this is so grime.
Airbrushing for the hockey team. And she was fucking Steve from the hockey team.
How do you know? Just from you found a number. How do you know she was fucking?
Researched? I found Steve. I found Steve.
You found him.
I found the name. And then she told me it was a cousin. And then I knew, man. I got that. You know when your chick's fucking around? Yeah. Isn't it? You know what I'm saying? There's that. You're not being what you are.
Yeah.
Your energy is fucking off a tick.
Yeah.
You didn't show up when you didn't answer the phone right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That eighth ring.
You fucking know. Yeah. And I knew. And I took her on the porch. And I go, I sat there for 2 hours. I lied to her. I was like, it's okay. I still love you. Things happen. You just tell me because I know there's nothing wrong. And then 2 hours and she goes, okay, Steve is a guy on the hockey team and we're having sex. I was like, I knew it, you fucking bitch. Fuck you, suck my dick. I was out. I left.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Wow.
So you know what that means, right? Karma, man.
Well, yeah. Mm. Your girl cheats is going to cheat on you.
Well, so different. Yeah.
But she's cool now. Like she, everybody I think gets their shit together at a certain point.
Is she a fat mess?
Nope. She's cool. She's got a husband. She's married. Okay. She's got kids. Her life is good.
How old were
Steve?
You?
I was 20.
That's
when I started going on a tear. That's when I started just fucking. I didn't want egg girl. I didn't
she get, made you go
in
on
reaction?
To, she turned you into the whole.
You know the next
reaction.
Girlfriend I had?
That's a natural reaction.
Next girlfriend? My wife.
Wow.
She made you Batman?
She made me Batman. You're absolutely right, Will. She made me Batman. You never had that?
Yeah.
Who?
I ain't gonna say her name, but yeah.
Yeah, we've all had that. That we happens to everybody, them. Right? I thought.
You've had a girl. You don't fuck.
No, Mike gets mad.
Everybody's had that crushing. Everybody's had that crushing heartbreak.
Who broke your heart? Jealous.
Girl, I was engaged to.
You were engaged?
Yeah. I was in Philly. I was going to do this. I was engaged. I was teaching.
Wow.
I was going to get married.
You were going to teach what?
I was teaching kids. Teaching kids with emotional problems.
Get the fuck out.
I have a master's.
And he developed emotional problems himself after that relationship.
And now you live with fucking Scopo?
No. No, I live with Soto.
Oh, you live with
Soto?
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Same thing.
Fucking A,
yeah,
man.
No. But that's the shit that pushes you. It pushes you to fucking... It drives
Mike
you.
Was fucked up behind that, man.
It fucks everybody up.
You was fucked up.
No, it fucked me up. It did fuck me up.
How fucked you up? How?
It hurt me. It hurt me bad.
Bang. How long?
It hurt me bad for
5 years.
Still
fucked up?
5, 7 years.
Not now. Now I've recovered. You know,
where is she? Married?
Married, yeah, kids.
Was it with the guy? Did she cheat on you?
Yeah.
With this guy?
What's that?
With this
guy?
Yeah,
yeah, I think so.
Oh,
I think so. But I'm pretty good about like not looking at the past at all. I'm pretty good about.
You don't
want to
wake those feelings up, man.
Yeah, I don't stew it. I'm not curious.
Was
that
this
way. It serves no purpose.
Was this pre-comedy?
Pre-comedy.
Wow.
Pre-comedy.
So that pushed them. Wow.
So that's how I started comedy.
Wow.
I started going to open mics. And I'm like, who gives a shit?
Because it was either comedy or kill this bitch.
That's Will's Haitian world.
It's either voodoo or you win.
The ring or the machete.
Oh, man.
No, but I feel like everybody's got that in their you know, everybody's got that heartbreak that fucking drives them to whatever thing.
Yeah.
To fuck a bunch of bitches or into comedy or to whatever.
That's
drives
why
you.
I did comedy, too.
Yeah.
I had a guy that I was in love with and... He wouldn't date me. He always would just do an open fucking thing, and he would always bring up his ex-girlfriend, and I was just so in love with him that I would just take it.
It didn't matter.
And then one night he came home drunk and started talking about the ex-girlfriend again, and I'm like, I just can't do this to myself.
Yeah.
But I was best friends with him and this other guy, and we all hung out in a group, and then it was just like, I can't hang out with this group anymore. I can't. All my friends are gone. This guy's gone. Everything's fucking, you know, over. So just go to open mics, you know.
See, I went to fucking because I just didn't trust women again. I just couldn't trust them. Every woman in my life had fucked me. Every woman in my life have done like. I felt like even my mom, any of them, anybody I ever met had taken advantage of me. And, you know, kind of manipulated me. And that that was the last one, because I was out there living my life, banging shit, and then I found love. And I trusted somebody. Again. Right. And here I am. Fuck.
That's crazy.
People suck. Oh, shit. So I went on a tear. I was like, fuck them all. And then it took, that's why it took me so long with my wife, because my wife was one of the good ones. My wife was a good person.
Hold on.
What?
Secretly, didn't you think these girls was not shit, and you, because we like challenges.
No, dude.
A lot of good girls probably came your way. You're like, I don't want them. I want the challenge.
Yeah, but he wasn't in the right place for it,
though. He didn't respect any of them.
Nah, he wasn't in the right place.
I was like, I told you, my thing was with a lot of these girls, I get them to suck my friend's dick.
What?
So I would get sexual. Like, I'd fuck around, talk dirty. I like freaky shit. And I'd get them like, oh, I would say, oh, shit, I think she likes Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if me and you were dating, I'd be like, she fucking likes Mike.
Mm-hmm.
I know this bitch likes Mike. Yep. I'd be like, you think Mike's hot? No. You'd suck his dick? No.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. You said, if I wanted you to suck his dick, why, do you want me to suck his dick? I'm just saying, is it kind of hot? And you'd be like, I don't know. And then while we're fucking, I'd be like, come on, tell me you want to. And you're like, oh, I want to suck Mike's dick. And then I get you to do it. And then in my head, I'm like, I knew it. You're not the one. I got you.
So
next.
So your wife didn't suck my dick?
No.
First of all, I'm glad for your speech impediment, because I would have thrown a fucking full poke in your head. I'll fucking kill you. No, Mike, whatever you said. No.
Mike,
see,
that was the defense mechanism.
I did the same thing too, man. I had a fair commitment, and I'm thinking, I'm the same, because last three girls, they cheated on me with some other dude. I'm thinking that's the story of my life.
That dick, dang.
Because they can't have sex with you. Mm-hmm. It's impossible.
Did you have any sexual problem with them?
Man, look, man, big dick ain't shit. Women's vagina stretched to let people out.
What?
That is true. That made a lot of sense.
Is it a Cuban prison? What does that mean? Oh, Jesus Christ.
It does. That's a good way to look at it.
Yeah.
The vagina lets people out.
Yeah.
But you got fucked up, too.
I got fucked up major.
But it's weird, because it's usually a woman that will heal that. You understand?
The right woman.
Yeah. My wife. My wife said, you can go on being a piece of shit, but I gotta go, or I'll help you not be a piece of shit.
And that was it? That's it. Quote, end quote?
Yep. I had to make that decision.
That should be a t-shirt.
Well, it'd be a long t-shirt. And people be like, what's that say? And it'd be annoying. Because you'd be like, what's that from? My wife said it. Oh, did she? And you guys, oh, fuck me. Fucking Will stinks.
That's a good quote, man. That's a good love. That's freaking awesome.
Yeah, that is great. Check.
And
you could keep on being a piece of shit, and I'm out, or I could help you not be a piece of shit. That's shit.
It took a long time. It still takes.
Did you get that when she told you that? Did you get that, by the way?
I got it right away, because I said, I don't know. Mm. Let me think about it.
Wow.
Because I wasn't gonna lie to her. Because at that moment, I could tell her exactly what she wants to hear. I will. And go back, and I fuck up again. And I was like, I need to go talk to somebody, because maybe I am a piece of shit.
Who did you talk to?
I talked to Patrice. I talked to Dane.
Keith?
I talked to Colin Quinn.
Wow.
And Dane and Colin said, let her go. No, Dane and Patrice said, let her go. Patrice said, you're a piece of shit, Bobby. Just be a piece of shit. And embrace your piece of shitness. And just let her go find whatever fucking plumber she needs to be with. Colin said, you can try. And in 6-8 months, be like, I'm a piece of shit. I'm sorry. Or you can not try and regret it for the rest of your life. Because he said, that's what I did. I didn't try, and I regret it.
That's what happened to me.
You didn't try.
I didn't try, and then I regret it. But it is what it is.
It's fucked up, right?
Yeah.
So I didn't. So I look at my son, and I look at my wife sleeping, and I'm like, fuck. It's all right. As long as I try, as you know what I mean? Shit, at this point, this is the funniest podcast ever.
I'm not gonna lie, I got teary eyed with that.
That's so beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
All right, listen, man, we are at an hour 48. I'm fucking exhausted. Wow. I'm sure the chat room is dead. We probably all left.
The chat room
only likes it when we're fucking smashing each other.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
You fags.
What's the chat room saying? This is gonna be fucked up.
Axiom says, I wonder if Cecil the Lion had any ass play. Nothing.
Nope.
Hedrick says, Scopo and Mike V should do a podcast and call it Tuesdays with Guidos.
That's pretty funny. I like that.
Axiom also says, Badass Bobby, doing karate and eating ass. Blinding Ape says, Mike destroyed on the Big J roast.
Mm. Yeah, I heard you did.
Yep. Yeah. Should I just keep going? This is all like bombing horribly.
Be confident.
Are you the boss? Are you the boss? Who's the boss?
You're the boss.
Did the boss tell you to stop?
No. So the boss didn't say anything. I was just looking.
I was fucking enjoying all of them.
Were you?
Yes. I laughed at the last one.
You gotta want to read them.
Believe in yourself.
You have a choice to make.
I do want
to
read them.
Make them work.
I like the way you read them.
Be a piece of shit. How many times do I tell you,
I like when you go, yeah, do you read these fucking forums, dum-dum?
Get your Reddit.
No, I don't. I really don't.
Good. What?
It's just the
say it.
You don't. He fucking reads the forums. All the.
I don't read the YKWD forums.
What do you read?
The Anthony Cumia ones, the Opie and Anthony ones.
What does that have to do with you?
It has nothing to do with me. That's why
I'm
I can read
he
them.
Wants to be on.
No.
$400.
Those forums are just.
Little bitch. Bitch.
He really would dump me.
Yeah.
He is waiting to get that fucking like the draft.
Serious. Yeah,
I'm telling you, every time
he's gone,
he listens to Anthony's show every day just to hear him go, "What the fuck's wrong with this? This is his dream. The fucking video's fucked up again. What the fuck do I gotta do?
Where's that Dupu guy?"
I don't know if he'd say it like that. I think he'd say Deepu.
I just like those forums because it's so tumultuous. They're all just shitting on each other. Like, it's never...
Yeah, that's a good healthy thing to read.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they're not talking about me, so that's always nice, too.
Yeah, but why do you like reading that? Oh, anyways, listen. All right, we're going to go. We're going to wrap it up. I got to go. Right now, this is coming out. I'm on vacation right now when this is out.
Okay.
Does this come out first or second?
I think this comes out second. Okay. I think we wait on this one. This one's a doozy.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Thank you. Yeah, you do have a thing about you.
Thank you.
Oh, shit. It is
delicious.
Because your hair is blonde, by the way, right?
Yes, naturally.
Yeah, yeah. You're like Elvis.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I want to see a picture. You got a picture?
Mike can look it up on Facebook.
No, I just saw her pubes with that dress.
You serious?
My pubes aren't blonde.
No, they're not brought. I can tell by her. She has a very Elvis thing about her.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Bubba.
Yes.
Where are you at? Tell me about your podcast first.
I just started a podcast. Mike was actually on it. He was within the first five episodes talking about how he loves to fuck sex workers. Was that what it was?
Yeah, my sexuals.
Yeah. It's called the Hot Mess Comedy Hour. It's recorded on the Keith and the Girl in the Keith and the Girl studio, if you guys are familiar with that podcast. Yeah. And it's myself and another female comedian. We just talk to fucked up comics about their fucked upness, and it's always a good time.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah,
it's on iTunes.
And what else you got?
You can find me on Twitter at Andrea Comedy, and that's about it.
Andrea, you're a very honest person, and you can take a fucking joke.
Thanks, buddy.
And you were great on the show today. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
Well, you got it. And Mike, what do you got?
This is going to be coming out a little later, so I'll say this. Follow me at Yo Mike Brown on Twitter. Check out the Comedy Outliers podcast. And speaking of that, depending on when this comes out, go to Union Hall on Saturday, August 22nd, 8 p.m. We're going to have a big show called Pop Americano, live show, multimedia. It's going to be great. Yeah, just check that out. Follow me on Twitter at Yo Mike Brown. Peace.
Yo, this is Will Silvins, WILSYLVINCE. Twitter, Instagram, everything. August 18, 19 is going down. School of Visual Arts. My film festival I've been doing for 10 years. 10th anniversary NBC Short Film Festival is happening August 18 and 19 at School of Visual Arts.
This comes out the 17th, so make sure everyone knows that.
Okay, this comes out the 17th, so 18 and 19th.
So it'll be that
come out tomorrow. Also, if you happen to be in Dubai, or September 4th, I'll be in Dubai.
With who? When did you become fucking international?
Don't worry about that, all that.
I am worried about it. It's bugging the fuck out of me.
And if you happen to be in China.
His dick is there now.
Didn't you just go to Dubai? Like last year?
That was last year. Yeah, they bring me back. And also, if you have, and I'm going to Abu Dhabi, by the way. Abu Dhabi.
What? How do you get that right?
I'm going, it's an hour from Dubai.
First of all, hurry up. I can feel my heartbeat in my fucking hamstrings. I've been sitting too long. Hurry up.
And that's it.
All right. What do you got,
Mike Vecchione, Twitter, at comic Mike V. Album is Muscle Confusion, available on iTunes.
Okay, what do you got, Deepu?
You can follow me at R2Deepu across the board, and I got a show August 24th at Hosteling International, so you can check that out. Thank you, Bobby.
You got it, buddy. It was disingenuous, but you're welcome.
I mean it every time.
Follow me at Chris Scopo on Twitter, and I'll be Labor Day weekend. I'll be at Uncle Vinny's. The whole weekend.
That's great, man.
So come back. Come out if you're around the Jersey Shore.
All right, man.
And then, Bobby's your dates. Salt Lake City.
I am on vacation. So make sure you guys watch the show. Have you guys seen the show?
I haven't seen it.
Sex, Drugs, and Rock and Roll. You guys are not my friends.
Literally. I've seen it. It's DVR'd. I haven't seen it yet.
Here's the deal.
People DVRing it.
Fuck. Okay, I need you to watch. Listen. Here's the deal. I've had fucking two comedian friends retweet shit for me.
I retweeted it. Can you send it to me?
Mike Brown. Mike Brown is a motherfucker.
Oh my God.
He's one of the only people.
Kidding me out here?
I'm telling you.
I'll retweet it tonight.
I'll retweet it Thursday,
motherfucker.
I'll retweet it
when it comes on.
Mike Brown, you ain't fucking around. You're a friend.
Send me a text and I'll retweet. I'll tell you.
All right, check it out. Thursday night, Sex, Drugs, and Rock and Roll on FX. Make sure you tune in. Hit the fucking button. Record the series and watch it. You guys, the ratings go up every week. It's been fantastic, but keep it going. And then where am I going to be?
Utah, Salt Lake City, 50 West Club, August 20, 21st, 22nd. September 5th, you're going to be in Pompton Plains, New Jersey, the Comedy Shop, one night only. And then September 24th to the 28th, you're going to be at the Just for Laughs Festival in Toronto.
And I just booked another tour with Just for Laughs. After that, I'm going to be doing half the tour in Canada. I'm going to be in Toronto for the JFL 42, and then I'm going to be doing the tour in Canada, which I'll be announcing soon, with I think it's 15 shows in Canada. So make sure, Canada, you've been begging, telling me, I'm coming back.
I'll
so go
Canadians.
To the shows.
I'll tell them all.
Please, Vancouver, one of my favorite places. All right, man, that's about it.
Where can I get a Robert Kelly Live at a Village Underground t-shirt?
RobertKellyLive.com.
Where can I get the CD?
I love that t-shirt.
CD? The DVD?
Yeah, the DVD.
Well, the DVD you can get for $5 at RobertKellyLive.com.
Okay.
And the album is on iTunes right now, and it just charted on Billboard.
Oh,
I'm going to get the whole package for a gift for somebody.
My first time I ever charted.
Nice.
I'm going to get the t-shirt and the album.
That's pretty big, you know?
Everything's turning up, Robert Kelly.
Robert Kelly, my favorite comedian.
You got?
Kiss ass.
That's it. Bobby is funny. I ain't gonna take that away from you. Funny as hell, dude.
Thank you, buddy. I love you too. You're very funny. You got very funny over the last year or so. you guys are the best fans in the world. In the chat room, thanks for sticking around for a double show today. You guys come in, you make it interesting. We love you guys. You guys listening live, awesome. You guys are listening on Mondays. Make sure you watch the YouTube. If you watch it, subscribe and review. At least subscribe. Make sure we will let you know. Deepa, what happens when they subscribe?
Our subscriber count goes up.
Oh, God.
No, you get notifications as to when we're going live.
No, it doesn't work that way. The notification system is, like, not that great.
I get notifications every time at 9 o'clock on
it
Sunday.
It works? Oh, yeah. Really?
This is why you're a fucking just a curmudgeon.
No, that notification is when our episode
Who
comes
gives
out.
A fuck?
All right.
We want them to subscribe.
Yeah.
So if they think
it's I mean, tell them subscribe.
Tell them if you subscribe, you get a free unicorn.
That's a pretty good deal.
Fucking make some shit up. One more time.
You
shit.
Get notification.
The show just fucking douched out. You gotta be kidding me, dude. The whole show's gone. All right. Fuck it. Goodbye.
Did we fucking lose that show?
We lost it. I got it. No, I got it. I got it.
Okay.
We got backups everywhere, dude. I got three backups. We're good. Guys, that was a great show.
Just say the sign off and then.
All right, guys. Thank you for listening. You know what, dude? I'll see you guys later.
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs. Check out riotcast.com for all of the best podcasts on the internet. And they are all free.